Hello. Happy Thursday. Hope everyone's doing well. Very shortly, I will be kicking off my story mode operations group, so I need to switch my gear. Got the duds on the wrong character. I have pepper between my teeth. It's very frustrating. I would like to continue to draw your attention to a GoFundMe that's really important to me right now. A dear friend who I've known since my day one sophomore year of college. She is unfortunately forced out of her house due to being assaulted by her next door neighbor and continued threats. The neighbor was released on cash bail with no action taken yet, so she obviously cannot return home safely. She has decided, despite absolutely loving her community and her area, that the safest and best thing to do is to move. And that sucks. Moving is very expensive, let alone trying to do it in a hurry where you don't want to, you know, even make eye contact with your next door fucking neighbor. So, I want to be as supportive as possible. She is getting everything lined up, and if you scroll down in the About Moxie section, there's a link to her GoFundMe. Every little bit helps so we can get Chyna out safely. Okay, without further ado, let's keep switching the gear over. Good evening, Vesperin. Okay. That should be everything. Oh my god, it's such a mess. Okay, log out. Is it Moxie time or is it Vesperin time? I think it's both. Since you'll be playing too. Goodness. How is it Thursday already? This week is like... You remember to sign up? Good, good! Hey, Casey, how are you tonight? I'm just switching my gear over. Oh god, everyone's bags are full. This is not good. Abort, abort. Thankfully, I was thinking EV, not EC. Shit. Okay, we're doing Explosive Conflict tonight, which is a really fun one.
Hold still.
Oh, for you, Dorn? Of course I'll hold still. Okay, good. I still have 4 minutes before I'm going to start forming the group, so I'm going to do what I always tell everyone else to do and empty my bags, check my frags. I already put on my pants. Got all my pants on. currency. Oh, thank god, that's not an issue. Okay. Of course, it's going to complain at me the entire night, but... Brilliant. Thanks, Vesperin. I'll send the invite very shortly. I just need to finish getting myself a little ready. Make sure you pop into RAIA 1 should not be taken. It is not. That's good. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh my god, so many things. How did my bag get so full? Those are good. That's all trash. So much trash. I would like room for activities. Instead, I have trash. Okay. There. That's somewhat better. There. Oh, these all need to go here. That'll help. Every little bit helps. Oh, there. There's more stuff I can discombobulate. I always think of it as discombobulating, not deconstructing. It's way more fun. Okay, cool. Now that I am much, much better, I'm going to jump in the group. Uh-oh. Diz is in there. Okay. Group 2. There we go. Okay. Okay, cool. And double check that I'm repaired. I am back down to the fleet. If you want to earn creds other than farming, conquest skill. Yep, that's one way to do it. Hey, Darklight. Happy Thursday. I mean, there's a lot of different strategies. Diz, I thought you were up in two. That's why, or up in one. That's why I moved down here. Can I have one?
You can have one. I'm just chilling.
Okay, cool. Thanks. All right. One.
I am switching my star perch to one.
Thank you much. Yes, I only jumped down there. I was already, yeah. Anyway. Blah, 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 blah. Vesperin, you're ready for an invite. Good. And group.
Hello.
Good evening. All right, now let me go pick. Oh, wait, it should be the group. It is the group finder today. Yay. But let's go pick up the weekly just in case, because I'm right there. In the meantime, please empty your bags, check your bags, repair your gear, put on your pants. Pants optional tomorrow per, it's the wrong thing, per machine's request. So I'm not enforcing pants tomorrow. I'm subbing managing story mode for him tomorrow. All right. If you are good to go, please X up in chat, and I will keep grabbing folks. Thank you. Dark Bane is Light Bane. Okay. Lies. All lies, man. Well, I always try and match people up. So I do. I keep my cute little spreadsheets here in front of me where I have the list of who's doing what role each day. Sarge is Tillwin.
I ran out of special characters to make Lightbane variations on all my tunes, so I just had to, you know.
Good. Fuck special characters. I hate special characters. They're such a pain in the ass. I can't believe the game even allows them.
There can be only one pure Lightbane. What can I do? And that name was stolen from me way back on the first server merge.
Oh, not poor fair. Thing. Poor thing. Casey and Vesper, I'm not saying you can't wear pants. I'm just saying pants are optional tomorrow. Just not today. Today is a normal Moxie run. Pants required. Tomorrow, where I'm subbing running machines run, I can't enforce my rules. I'll try, but... everyone, make sure you are in Star Parse 1, please. And we'll just wait up on our healers. Oh, uh-oh. Someone didn't accept the... Oh, there we go. There's Gren Nicole. Perfection. And I see both Kevin and Torlamain getting on. Perfect.
Yep.
How much can I bring on the flight? I don't know. However much vodka you can sneak on for me, Exodus. Alrighty.
If you get shit-faced sampling the little mini bottles.
It takes a lot of mini bottles to get me shit-faced.
Fair enough.
yeah. Okay. So we're in RAIA1. I have the quest to share. We will be doing explosive conflict. Is anyone here new to explosive conflict?
No, but it's been a long time since I've been there.
Fair enough.
Same.
That's funny. You're just talking about getting shit-faced and you're going to do explosive diarrhea.
No.
I'm up a ladder and you hear some splatter diarrhea.
Ew.
Basically with the trash in that operation.
Moxie, you didn't hear those old grade school rhymes. Those are older than me.
I don't spend a lot of time with children anymore, thankfully.
Oh, when you were in grade school, silly Billy.
Yes, a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. You logging in, Turlamine?
We're just being a little pokey.
Mm-hmm.
Music. At time.
No, I was sharing a picture with my girlfriend yesterday, and she's like, wow, that was 19 years ago. And we're like, oh God, we're so old. It was our high school graduation.
That you little whippersnapper. Meh. Mine was 90. Meh.
Good evening, everyone.
Evening. Hello. Manicore. All right, as soon as Charlemagne logs... Oh, there he is. Perfection. Yep. On Cheeky tonight. And everyone, make sure you are in Star Parse 1. S'il vous plaît. I am seeing 6.
Need an invite before I can hop in.
Fine. Hey there.
It's all green, but I don't see anybody in it.
Oh, you'll see it in the little bar in gray text.
Under the tabs, in the middle kind of area. You'll see RAIA #1 in bold, and then to the right of that, paren 7, and then you'll see the rest of us who are there, and then you'll see yourself.
It's kind of tricky that way.
Sneaks! So I'm going to share the quest just for the weekly. There we go. But it is today's group finder, so I'm not going to rearrange the raid frames yet because Torlamain's going to become the group leader. Unless something bizarre all get out happens and he's suddenly not the most popular in the group, but it'll be Torlamain. Shal, do you want to drop or you want me to?
Missions again, pretty please.
Oh, sure.
I can drop.
Cool. Thank you. That'll be easier.
I'm out of here.
Bye. Never to be seen again.
Feels bad. Wow, man.
Still want a damn.
I need my other tank. I can't solo tank this one.
I bet you could.
Really? Really? Firebrand and Stormcaller?
Yeah.
I would need one hell of a tank. I'll tell you what.
Uber.
Like the tankiest fank ever to fank. All right. Everyone, please hit your activity finder. Make sure you're signed up for one role and one role alone, and that is in fact the correct role that you are signed up to play today. Kevin, you're so quiet.
I'm here.
Okay, cool. if everyone's set, Shal, you ready to queue up?
Hey, Moxie, can you share the quest pretty please? You got distracted by something shiny.
No, I hit it 3 times, man.
Logged in, I missed it. Hang on.
Cheeky is already on mission. Weekly explosive conflict, man.
Oh, sorry, mutt derp. Dang, fries are burnt. Okay. I owned up to it.
Like, the proof is in the chat window, man. I gotcha. No, I'm always good to double check. Shal, you ready to play the game?
Yep.
Queuing now. Everyone, please do not hit ready unless it is both Explosive Conflict and Shal.
No D&D multiclassing.
Not today.
Sorry, I think I hit the climax.
Weirdo. Again, please don't hit anything. EC and Shal. We're good. Woohoo! Only took 5 tries today. Bethel had fuck all for luck the other day. That was ridiculous.
That tested his Canadian patience.
What did? Oh yeah, right. When sweet Canadian Bethel is like, you can hear him grinding his teeth through his mic. we're all just like, are you kidding me?
He was really close to saying, fucking shit balls.
It was not pleasant for anyone. The hell's that smell? Okay. If you haven't been here before, pick up the one-time quest.
This 3 months. Out with the cap part. Sounds that this a strike.
And head on in. Ooh, do we have any stealthers who want to volunteer for a solo hike?
I can try. I might fail craptastically, but I can try.
Just keep it low and slow. Stay to one side. Don't run down the middle.
Do not run down the middle?
Correct.
Well, which side should I stay on?
Either or. Just head on out and,
Take like a baby and head on out? Gotcha.
Yep, everyone else stay put at it here. So, for those who haven't been here before, haven't been in a while, there is a path that he's going up right now that, has a bunch of trash mobs that are really kind of annoying. Oh, and I'll rearrange the right frames now. They are totally skippable by... I'm sorry. I will not rearrange the right frames now. Don't let me!
Hey, now how she shakes her pudding.
Hey, Mr. Popula. Thank you, dear.
How you doing, so?
Mind sharing a little of that prom king magic? There we go. Okay. So, if you have a stealther in the group, they can, if you hit M, you can look at where he's going all the way up and around the path. Uh-oh, that's a different path, but okay. And...
Shit, pick a five!
Alright. You know where you're going, though. If you hit M, you're going to Zorn and Toth.
Anyway, eventually.
You go up, and he'll target one of the, guys, and then stealth out again. Everyone else, just stay put. That'll drop, ideally. And, then the speeder will appear on this cute little landing pad right in front of us, and we'll be able to pop right on up to Toth and Zorn. Toth and Zorn are a fun group. We're going to split by raid frames. Once we're ready.
Don't think I'm gonna make it.
Nope, he's toast. Alright, just zone in and we'll clear trash. We'll make
I can run unless you want to clear trash.
Everyone, stay back, stay back, stay back, stay back, stay back, stay back. Who was it who volunteered?
I can.
Oh, great, Shell. Shell's turn. Everyone else hang back here. Extra cool if you have two cloaks.
I have two cloaks and two stuns.
Nice.
Yeah, the champion one's dingy.
Yeah, you have to really keep an eye out and stay out of the way. And or be able to like use your main stealth most of the time and then pop your cloak and like there's a dance to it. It's not as obvious as it seems. Right, exactly. So well, yeah, you do. You have your normal stealth and your emergency stealth. Don't you? Yeah, you have an in combat stealth out, right?
I looked at Trick move, but something had it grayed out because I was looking for where the hell's my combat stealth?
Yeah, that's weird. I always have to use both. Because then when you get up to Toth and Zorn, you poke one and then you use your in combat stealth to not die. I mean, unless you want to solo take down the first bosses, but to each his own.
Yeah, that goes back to that argument everyone can tank just for a matter of how long.
So true. Me tank you long time.
Well, alright then.
You guys are just giving me extra time to finish my drink before we get going. I like it.
Yep. Not sharing with the class.
I would totally share my vodka. That's why I buy a case at a time. Oh wait, no, that's just for me. I would buy two. I would buy two cases if I have guests.
Their little dozen, my preciouses.
When I lived with two other women for over 2 years in college, I was the first to turn 21, so I was like the designated booze purchaser. I'm like, no fine.
Such a naughty enabler.
I feel like they weren't going to get it.
All right,
anyway.
Shal, you going to poke one?
Giggity.
Cloaks on timeout, but I'll just
perfect.
Let
him go. All right, everyone.
There we go. We're
hop
good.
A speeder. Well done.
Wunderbar.
And jump on down. All right, so we're gonna split by raid frames. I will take Zorn on the left. Shell and team will take Toth on the right. Please remember, with Zorn, do not be within 25 meters. Very, very important. Actually, let me double check raid frames. I've got a guardian and a sage. Sage and a go. Okay, I'm switching two of you. Yoink. Better. There we go. So now we have the ranged on zone. We're going to tank them against the walls opposite each other. Don't stand in front of them. Right side is on Toth. Correct. We don't have to do any tank swaps here, but best practice, don't be running up and down the middle. Otherwise, poke them in the tushy. Don't stand in big purple circles. That's kind of it. Shal and I are going to be communicating, ideally, well, so that we burn them at about the same time, because when one hits 10%, they push to enrage. We want to get one to about 15, stop, finish the other off. Ideally, we want to get Zorn to about 15, finish off Toth, then finish off Zorn. At that point, the dude up in the tent is going to jump on down, and he is the squishiest little bastard known to man, so we're going to, like, give him a little nasty look, and he's going to fall over dead. Yeah, so the red reticles, again, don't stand in stupid. They'll explode and hurt a wee bit. But, any other questions? Make sure you, let me guard, Astracella, and Shal, if you would guard Cheeky. Everyone make sure you have your stims, med packs, ready to go. Okay, and red check. Board's green. We're gonna wait until they're in, kinda nice positions. They're pretty damn close. Shal, you ready to rock?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, pulling in 3, 2. Oops, that was totally the wrong button. We're at 80.
We are 84.
Nice. Good. Seventy-five. If Johnny or Gren could toss an occasional shot over to Toth, that would be nice. We're at 57. Oh, nice. They're like perfectly matched right now. Granicore, you don't want to be that close, ever. You want to make sure you are 25 meters or more.
Or bad juju happens.
It does. A lot more bad juju in vet mode and master mode, but you know me. I like to... Best practices. Good. Enforce best practices. Okay, we're at 30. What's top?
27.
Nice. Yep. Zorn at 15.
16. Yeah, we're 16, 15 now.
Burn, burn, burn on both sides, guys. We're matched beautifully. And then, Shal, will you pick up the ad dude? Perfect. All right, Handler Murdoch. Is interruptible. BT dubs.
Bastards.
Well done.
Forgive me.
Get your loot, and we'll keep on hustling up the road. Cute, ugly crystal.
Hey, orange has its purpose.
I hate the color orange.
For reals?
I really do.
No pumpkin pie for Moxie.
See if you can find an alternate route through the mine. All right, Taskmaster first on this next group. Pull in 3, 2. I like orange food.
There you go. It's got good beta carotenes in.
Oh, I meant like macaroni and cheese.
Well, yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. Aesthetics only. Yes, I love nacho cheese too. 5-year-old logic. I understand.
You know, I do love orange food though. Like, I love carrots. I eat a lot of carrots.
There you go.
Although I got the most beautiful green beans a couple days ago. So last night I made this gorgeous, like, green bean with walnut saute thing. Oh my god, it was divine.
Get you some slivered almond, you can make that fancy Eric O'Vear almondine.
Yeah, I had the walnuts already, so.
There you go.
Stick with what you got. I really work hard to reduce food waste. Everyone's been here once, right? Then we don't have to get the thingy. Okay, cool. We're gonna head off to the right. We're gonna let that one Druke Labor head out all the much further. I'm gonna grab the Druke Labor. Everyone, Shal, can you grab that Taskmaster? And we're gonna try and group them all up. Everyone, Laborer first, then Taskmaster, then Cleanup Crew. Pulling in 3, 2. Perfect. Taskmaster next. Beautiful. Now we're going to head up and pick off the next Druke.
Make him go to sleep. Never mind.
Nice. Very nice.
Like I say, it seems a lot of champions have immunity.
I used Tenacity to get out of his thing. So, he does stun the first thing that attacks him. It can be a little annoying.
It's like Duroc Halitosis.
Yep, so Shal gets to ping the next one up here. Or I can haul it back. Here we go. Yoink! Yep, and I'm stunned. So these trash mobs will have invisible friends that will join us. I will remember to use my stealth scan. We're going to start on the left with the cannoneer. Shell is going to jump right to the Druk laborer. I'm going to pull the cannoneer and everyone else over. Everyone, Druk, then cannoneer, then the others should fall into line. On your count, Shell.
Oh, do you have your tiara?
Two, oh, one.
You know, some girls want the mic set with the kitty ears. Mine might just need a tiara attachment.
You don't want to be an anime kitty lady?
That's just not my style. That would have been my style in, like, junior high.
Yeah, but there's still a lot of cosplay cuties out there that rock that look.
Sorry, my Sith Inquisitor cosplay doesn't do it for you. Fine.
No.
All black head to toe with all the, you know, big shoulder armor and everything. Hey, I worked hard. I got that thing tailored just right.
I know, it's a very good job.
Thank you. It's the most fucking comfortable cosplay I've owned in my life. It's my favorite. It has pockets.
Knocking something practical.
And it's easy to take off short gloves with
and you can go pee easily when you need to.
Yeah, exactly. It's pants. And comfortable boots. Like, there isn't any... I mean, the cape is the most dangerous, troublesome part, and even that's not bad at all. Alright, let's ride on up to the next group. Honk, honk. I recommend not dying to log boss.
Captain Dennett here. Enemy reinforcements closing on your position.
Next group's here. Oh, come on. Seriously?
I think I fucked that up for you.
I just wanted to yank him down. He was not yankable. I don't think you... I mean, unless you did something that stunned him in place.
No, I think I rode up and activated him.
Oh, no, that's fine. I mean, even after he's active, I can still... I should have been able to... theoretically, harpoon his little tush down, but nope.
Yeah, I mean, I remember I would, on my jug, I would leap up to him, and it would immediately knock me back down, so I wonder if there's something.
He's like, smacks you off and say, no sale!
Yeah, exactly.
Alright, cannoneer's first.
No.
Cannoneer's first, please. Sorry.
Kind of impromptu prioritizing.
You know.
Herding cats for the win.
Well, this is why I'm worried if we get 16 people tomorrow. That's just not my comfort zone.
Be like Tweak on South Park. Too much pressure!
Why are they stealing my underwear? Step one, steal the underwear. Step two, question mark. Step three, profit. Great episode.
Pervy little underpants gnomes.
Yep. All right. Have a nice conversation with the door. All right. These are our tanks. There are many like them, but these are ours. we are again going to split by raid frames, with Firebrand on the left and Stormcaller on the right. Shall, you good with that?
Yep.
Keen. Okay. Shall and I are going to be standing front and center on the noses of the tanks. Everyone else, is, well, Johnny and Gren are going to be here on the inside of this tank, and Darkbane and Tilwyn are going to be on the inside of this tank. Okay, so you'll note that they start, they are in offensive positions. We will jump up and pew pew. They will go into defensive positions, aka they will tilt their noses back and pew pew into the air. There will be shielded stuff. It is always on the outsides of the tanks in story mode, which makes things really, really, really easy. So, Johnny and Gren, you're going to run over there and kill those folks. Opposite, you guys know what you're doing over there. Make sure you don't attack the spike in the middle of the shield. Which tank would like to be on running duty?
It's been a minute, but I can run around. What do you want me to do?
I'm sorry, which healer?
I can... I'm sorry, healer.
I misspoke. I need Kevin or Torlemaine to volunteer as tribute.
I put in my request in chat. Not it.
I haven't healed this one before, but if you tell me what to do, I can do it.
Okay, so while the rest of us are up on our tanks, and Torlemaine will be up on that inside of Stormcaller with the rest of the team, you are going to be running up and down between here and here. There will be spikes targeted at you. Don't stand in them. So little purple circles will be pew-pewed at you. You're basically the sacrificial lamb running around, so it's like, pay attention to me! You're the one running around waving your hands in the air, so everything's paying attention to you and not us. And then when we go into defensive positions, run over and, you know, just try and make sure those of us over on the outside are of Firebrand on the left side here are healed.
Okay.
I'm not sure, Cheeky, but they're very clear. Like, he'll know. They're, as long as you're paying attention, and I think we're sturdy enough that we aren't going to need a whole ton of extra heals. Okay, so once we kill the guys on the actuals on the sides and they go back into offensive positions, by the way, there's a countdown on the cast bar, so you know. So don't run out early. You need to be under that shield to stay safe. Once they go back into offensive positions, we'll jump back on the tanks. Please note that on, for instance, Firebrand, you can jump up on the outside and run straight through his head over to the inside where you should be. So I hope everyone sees why we want everyone on the insides so that the healers can help each other and reach more people. That's the whole concept. Again, like with Toth and Zorn, we want them to die at about the same time, so we're going to be communicating that. That's the other cool thing about having everyone hang out on the insides, is it then makes it easier to transition and say, like, jump over onto Firebrand kind of thing. We'll make those calls as we go. But otherwise, make sure you get under shields as soon as possible. Wait until it's back in offensive positions to get back on the tank. Get on the tank as quickly as possible. Big pew-pews. Never stand in front of the tank unless you are a tank, because there's a front conal, and it stings a little, even in story mode. Like, you don't want to be there. Questions, concerns, love letters.
So after the defensive, do I just go back to keep running in the middle?
Yep.
And it's a rinse-repeat for the fight? Okay.
The entire fight's very much rinse-repeat.
Okay.
Cool. Good questions. Good questions. You should also mount up at this point, because once we get going, we want to get on them as soon as possible. So, everyone ready to rock and roll? Let's kick some ass. 3, 2, 1, let's ride, bitches!
Engaging hostiles for the masses!
Defensive systems, ads on the sides. Go to the ads.
Engaging offensive systems.
Remember, don't use AoEs and don't attack that spike in the middle.
the hell?
Too late.
What happened on the right side? That's a wipe.
Yeah. So everyone slash stuck. And let's talk. What happened?
We landed in the shield and they were taking out the ads. The spike dropped on us.
Do I need to stay in the middle the whole time?
You cannot run to everyone else. Yes. Sorry. Yes.
Sorry. I misunderstood. That was my fault.
I may have said it poorly. Okay. Everyone, return to area start. It's not a short schlep. It's okay. Jeez. Learning curve. No, this has a lot of weird mechanics. It's a weird looking one. Faux show.
Yeah, the last time I did this, I was just a sentinel, so.
Just a sentinel. Now you're sentinel in my heart. No.
So once inside the shield thing, only single target attacks?
Yeah, correct. No AoEs, or else you'll break the generator.
Yeah. So that spike in the middle is what's keeping the shield up. If you down that shield, you aren't protected, and you're going to die.
Enter the bone zone.
You're going to have a bad time. Otherwise, everyone kind of get the concept of where you need to run, where you need to be.
Not the movement depth. I just need to remove my AoEs off this bar.
Yeah, yep. So I'm sitting here trying to figure out what I have that's actually just single attack.
Well, and as long as you're pointing it away, like if your back is to the spike and it's an AoE type thing that goes only forward, you have to be really careful. And this is definitely this is absolute best practice for a vet mode thing, but you need that shield. Remember to hug the left when you're coming up, because there will be a group of ads over on that right side that we did not clear. They're sneaky little bastards up in the tree. Kevin! You don't want to be here? I see how it is.
What? I didn't say that.
I'm just teasing. He typed in Twitch that, you know, he's participating for once rather than just moderating, and that's weird. Okay, I got my guard on Azrasella. Shal, if you can guard Cheeky. Everyone else, stims, repairs, all that jam. Mount up. And ready to check. All right, take two. We got this. Pulling in 3, 2, 1.
Engaging hostiles for the masters.
Yeah, that was the yellow indicator I was talking about, Moxie.
Defensives, everyone to the sides.
And you can get a free boost.
Yeah. Except tanks and healers.
Better.
Uh-oh.
Oh, what happened?
What happened, Mike, guys?
Mike's in the shield again.
I was in the middle this time with me.
Shal, were you under that shield? Everyone slash stuck. Shal, you can't be under that shield either.
Captain Danik,
tanks have to stay out.
I'll be liaising between your group and the main assault on Kephas.
The learning curve is real, and that's just fine.
So when you're tanking, do you just stay on the nose, or where do you go during that?
I go over close enough to help pew-pew a tiny bit, the folks under the shield. But I can't go under the shield.
Can you pull those guys out of the shield?
I can.
Okay, because I don't have any range is the only reason I asked.
Yep. Yes.
Copy.
I did bad.
You AoE'd?
No, I went to the med center and said,
No!
All right, well, run on back in, man.
How do I get back in?
Well, where are you?
On the fleet.
Okay, well, then you're going to hit quick travel. You're going to go to the Gav whatever, right?
Daragon.
Sure, Gav Daragon. And then you're going to go to whatever planet we're on.
Can you click on just the group finder thing?
Oh, yeah, you might. Yeah, you should be able to group finder. So hit your activity finder and quick travel.
Ah, yeah, there's
cool. Good call there. Phew. And then hustle on back. Not that we haven't all done that multiple times. I know I have. They really need to just fucking disable that thing. If I want to leave the operation, I can leave the operation logical ways.
Rage quit like a D-bag.
Yes, only DPS under the shields, correct.
No AoE DPS under the shield, right?
No AoE DPS unless it's a conal that you control and it's pointing away from the spike in the middle.
Win it out, don't whip it out.
From the hotkey bar.
Yeah, it's one of those better safe than sorry. Like, I just don't use it when I'm on my assassin. Like, there's no value. It's only
Moxie.
Only
did
risk.
You hear about the Moxie on Mars breaking down carbon dioxide into oxygen?
I've been reading about that for months. Vespin
I
knows
talked
this.
About it this morning in the general chat.
I know. I replied. It's very exciting.
Or she get her Lumberg impersonation when she rides up to Jet Propulsion Labs. Like, yo, where my check, bitches?
Well, I mean, it's only an hour away. Oh, and the company that made the camera that's on Percy's long arm, right here in San Diego.
Ah.
Yeah.
Nice.
There is so much about Percy and the helicopter and everything that are all, like, really local to me, and I'm, like, super nerd out on this stuff. Okay, so anyway.
Someone had a nerdgasm.
I do. I'm the type to, like, stay up until 4 a.m. to watch launches and hatch openings and all of that. Like, I really, really, like, sincerely nerd out.
Yeah, those SpaceX launches are cool.
There's one going on tonight. Crew 2 is going up tonight at 3 in the fucking morning.
Yeah, but did you see that the Russians were thinking about being dick farts and making their own space lab where they want to pick up the red ball and go home?
So this team has a Japanese, a French, and 2 Americans. And one of the Americans, UCLA and UCSD. She is one of us. Anyway, ready check again. You guys get me talking about space, we're going to be here all night. But yes, Moxie made oxygen on Mars, and it's the coolest fucking thing ever. Okay, board's green, pulling in 3, 2, 1.
But do we want to confirm Matt Damon's other experiments that you can grow potatoes with poop?
I bet it you can. I mean, they're drinking recycled piss all the time.
Who hasn't done that?
I have not. I can actually say I have not. Okay, sides, defensive systems.
So I'm just supposed to hang outside the shield
and
tank these little spiky things around.
Yep. Just don't, yeah. Exactly.
Is there a pattern I want to put them in, or does it just matter?
Nope, they're going to hit you. You can't avoid them.
I might have force pushed an ad out of the shield. I hope nobody gets mad.
All right, back up on. Uh-oh.
Shit.
Don't run in front, Granicore. And yeah, can we get Kevin back up, please?
Yep.
Thank you.
We're at 62? 60? How about you guys?
We're at
70.
Okay. Defensive? Oof. And I took a spike. That should not have landed on me.
I don't have enough force to get you up. Give me a second. Okay, apparently I can't click on my heal.
Heal thyself, man. Heal thyself.
You can use a heal cheeky if you got one, brother.
On it. You were just out of reach on from earlier.
I was running around. That was my bad.
Always. You got you.
You're the man.
And I'm right on the nose whenever.
I got you.
Thank you.
Oh, that's the spikes. Spikes are back.
Okay. No, we can handle this. Pointing off to the side.
Repulsion system charged and ready.
40%?
37.
36.
Defensive?
Engaging offensive systems.
Cheeky, where are you hanging? You're running around the middle, right, Cheeky?
I'm in the shield.
Okay.
Yeah, now you're staying in range. Good deal. Now it ain't no thing but a healing thing.
Nice.
Man, I like those and chicken wings.
True that, sure.
Get back?
Oh, yeah.
She was leaving us in suspense there.
25% on Firebrand?
Same here.
Nice. Should be our last defensive systems.
Oh, shop.
Oh, crap. Ow, defenses. Sorry, that's me.
Spikes. Balls.
It's okay, we might be able to clean this up.
Sloppy seconds for the win.
Everybody's dead on the right side.
I know, but we're at 14.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Go.
Up your defenses, you got him.
Yeah, my nerd down now. Nope. Damn.
Want me to stay on the tank with Shell and then just heal the group?
Yes.
From afar? Okay. Will do. We will tweak that shit.
Were you doing something different last time? You were supposed to be on the tank the entire time.
I was hopping in the shield with them, but we weren't getting spiked until something changed. Captain
Danik, oh, no. I mean, you should be in the defensive shield with them. Absolutely. Yes.
The problem
with Shell and Rain.
Spikes should only be on Kevin.
Weird. They were definitely going after Shell at some point.
Liked him.
Yes.
And the when they went in defensive systems, they started going after Shell and not me.
Can't confirm that because I was right next to Shell and got.
Yeah, and I got one too. I mean, that's what killed me.
Liked.
Okay, when I get up there, I'm going to pull up my notes real quick and just double check that we aren't missing something important.
Take a repair break.
Yeah, that whole first defensive system, Shell was cutting spikes the entire time.
That should not be.
He's supposed to.
Oh.
I'm supposed to get, am I not?
Tank does.
take those?
Players go to whoever has aggro on Storm.
Okay, so thank you, Diz. So, yes. So Shal is taking Storm. He will also have spikes. What are you saying, Diz?
Same thing.
Okay. So Shal will need to bob and weave as well.
But only during defensive systems?
Only during defensives, yep.
Correct.
Got it. So the Shinai be under the shield then?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Shal, no.
No. No.
You're basically, so basically you're taking the spikes from the healer so that the healer can go under the shield. Is the way it's designed.
Okay. Thank
but,
you.
But still be in range for me, like, to stay on that corner or front where I can still reach you.
Yeah. Yep.
So, sorry, where am I supposed to be standing during defensive systems? Just stay in the middle?
No, under defensive systems, you go under the shield. That's when Shal gets the spikes.
Okay. And then when we go back, I go back to the middle.
Correct.
Okay.
Okay.
That explains why we wiped the first time.
Yes. Guards back up. Everyone know where they're supposed to be?
Yep. My need to repair armor. I popped up a field repair droid in case anyone needs it.
Thank you.
There's a Revan statue. Also.
Okay. Board is green. Pulling in 3, 2, 1.
Engaging hostiles for the masters.
Defensive. 80% defensives.
Engaging offensive systems.
Back up. We're at 63. 70.
Okay.
Engaging defensives. Back on.
Around 50.
48, 47. So good.
54.
If Gren and Johnny, you can throw an occasional one over on Storm. But not right now. Now is defensive systems time.
Engaging offensive systems.
Thank you.
back on?
Yep. Yep, thanks, Johnny.
Stormcrawler's at 19.
Perfect. Now we're matchy matchy. Defensive? And back on.
Same.
7.
2.
Burn, burn, burn on both sides. Good job.
We own that shit that time.
Phew, yes. Wonderful, wonderful. Oh, and we, of course, still have some defensive assholes still up. So, trash cleanup.
Can we AoE now? Can we AoE now, please?
Yes,
please?
You can! to your heart's delight! Nice, and then don't forget to come back and get your individual loot from Mr. Storm, or Firebrand.
What is this jerky schematic? What is this thing?
It makes food.
It helps you. It's used as a lure to get a little tauntaun pet.
Get a tauntaun pet.
Ooh, nice.
Kephas has set up a major Beradian processing operation. Could be stocking up for a major galactic offensive.
Need a biochem to craft it.
Yarp.
Well, luckily I am a biochemist.
You get to cook stuff with liver in it. Eww.
Oh, are there still things back there alive?
I'm not in combat.
Me either.
I just got a very late, conquest. Okay, cool. There's everyone. Okie day. I'm going to grab the, what is this dude? Security droid on the left. Shall, if you can grab the security droid on the right. Everyone, security droids first, and then burn the ads. Pulling in 3. And don't stand in red circles.
Oh.
Just a thought.
All these tyrannical demands. No pants, don't stand in red circles.
Oh, tushy.
I'm the worst.
Right?
I don't know why you guys keep signing up to hang out with me for 2 hours at a time. You're the crazy ones. I just show up. All right. Bombardiers first. Pulling in 3, 2, 1.
Like blister little goober asses, every one of them.
I'm not judging your life choices. Well, yes, I am.
Passive aggressive. Observations, but that's different.
Don't judge me.
Man,
Fotor really hates AMD graphic cards.
I mean, who doesn't? They're overheating
POSs. Hey, people who can't... Look. I live in the jungle. Shit's expensive over here, all right?
That sounds like a personal afford... life choice.
Right.
Supportive like messages.
I forced my parents to be born here and make me down here. That is
pretty much it. I mean, and you should be held responsible. This is why I'm a firm believer in the veil of ignorance. But that's a societal lecture for another time. Bombardier in the middle first, and I'll try and haul that frontliner down. Shell, can you grab the bombardier, please?
Yep. 3, 2, 1.
Don't stand in this red circle. Hey, that was fun. Let's do it again.
I don't wanna.
Then just tag along and keep me alive.
Yeah, the trash pack.
I'll leave a trail of cookies for you. How's that, Kevin?
Okay.
Okay.
Chocolate. I don't hear it because I'm too busy eating.
Okay. Cookies are for winners, though.
Uh-oh.
No. Bullshit with cookies, man.
You get the first cookie free.
That's how they get you.
That's how we get you.
It's like a cookie pusher.
Now you're turning into Sesame Street on HBO Max. See, that's a...
Oh, hey, don't make me mourn.
Hey, boys, I got some great cookies.
So I had HBO Max for free for the first... Thank you, Rob. I will partake of the fisherman's food. I had HBO Max for like the last year or so with my cable, and like they didn't cancel it when they should have. They canceled it.
Shocker! It benefits them on
Days ago, and I'm like, but fuckers, I want to see Mortal Kombat. All right, please do not faceplant into the red wall.
Well, it's not very expensive to just buy it yourself.
I'm a really cheap bitch. Like, really cheap. Like, I was discussing with my mother today this, like, Caesar salad she buys at Trader Joe's that's, like, $8. I'm like, yeah, I made a really nice chicken Caesar salad today. I broke down the cost of all the ingredients and everything. $1.80. Including really nice cheese. Anywho, Shal, you want to go up or stay down?
I've never done
it. Don't skip on your dog, Moxie, so you spoil her.
Oh, of course. She's getting groomed on Saturday. I'm sorry, Shell, up or down?
I've never done up, so I can do up there. You want to be fast.
Can you res me?
The hell?
I forgot not to jump up on the wall.
By the way,
eaten by a wall.
Don't jump on the wall.
Don't jump on the walls.
Someone was bored.
I told you I forgot.
100,000 credits.
I am a chronically bad jumper. I jump in every game as I'm standing around.
Okay, well,
I'll go down.
Deep breath, stay still. Shell's going down tonight, so making my evening.
Diamond at the
wow. Hey, it's Thirsty Thursday. You know I'm going to feed off of that. I'm Jesus not going to. I can't not feed off that kind of thing. All right, so... the start of the fight is going to be on me, based on when I take this little elevator up to the top, I will release droids. You guys are going to snake down on the left side of the minefield. Stay in the square as a team, only be in a green square. At any point after you kill the big droid that I send your way, you are going to have two people with pliers that can dismantle the next bomb. Only one person can go at a time, so please, for the love of God, holy, shout. I'm going, because I will not have visibility into that. You guys really need to say, I have pliers, I'm next, you know? I got dismantled. I will be doing my best to make your path along the left as clear as possible. But again, backs to the wall, because the big droid that I'm sending your way does a knockback. This is interruptible. So, everyone, who has first interrupt?
I can grab it. What's the name of the ability?
Forget it. It's orange. He actually has two abilities, but, shit.
Overload and cleave.
Thank you. Cleave is the one that's very, very important to interrupt. Lightbane will get it first time. Who's got second?
I'll get it second time.
Great. Granicore's got it second. If you miss or you accidentally use your interrupt on overload instead of cleave, just say it. Just let us know so that someone else can pick it up and fill in the spot. Otherwise, you're going to burn down those big droids. Every time you kill the big droid, you'll get the pliers to move forward, but you can't move forward until I mark something as orange up on this beautiful grid. I will do my best. Otherwise, we're going to have the whole team sneak along the entire left wall. If you zoom out a lot, you will see at the far end, there's a ramp of dirt going up to the end. On the bottom right is a box that disables the minefield. If someone would be so kind as to click that, I can come join you guys, which is helpful because at the top of that ramp is going to be the actual final boss, he with two friends. So we will be tanking him with our backs to that cave. So facing the opposite direction we are now, you don't want your back down to the ramp. Now, imagine with your back to that cave, you're facing forward. There's going to be turrets that appear on each side. We are going to leave the, when you're looking with your back to the cave and looking forward, the backmost right one up. I'll mark it with a target, but don't attack that one, because if it takes us longer than normal to kill the boss, and you kill all the turrets respawn. So you always want to just leave one turret up, kill the boss, then finish off that turret. Otherwise, keep your backs to the wall, communicate well about disarming bombs. I will try and send the droids as quickly as possible and open up the right grids as much as possible. Questions?
I've never done this before, and I was just confused. What's the priority when the little droids are coming in this pit area?
Little droids. Oh, so...
Well, not little droids, but when you send the droids in the pit area, what's the biggest priority? Keep them occupied until somebody gets a wrench, basically?
No. Kill them. Kill them with Fi-Fi. Burn.
Okay.
Burn that big droid. There will also be occasional smaller droids that will march toward you. They burn off really easily. But the big droid, I'm going to actually have to go, like, hunt and find it, and that's how I send it your way. That's what gives you the pliers to disable the next bomb.
Okay, cool. I get it now.
It's a weird system, but you'll see the grid appear once we unlock the first one. Okay, everyone should group up to kind of the left of me. And be prepared to jump down as one tight unit to the left and be ready for that first grid to appear. Wait until I'm going to jump down first based on the timing of this ramp thing. So next time it comes down to the bottom, I'm going to go. All right, and let's rock. Stick together and hug that left wall. But don't go out onto the minefield until I expose a grid. Board's green. Go to it. Alright, going to find you a droid. The fuck is it? Got it. Okay. Sending you the droid, stay in your green grid, and kill that droid. Backs to the wall. Because of that cleave, it does a knockback. Make sure you get those interrupts.
Got the first one?
Okay. Mark, whoever, one person with pliers, go forward. One person with pliers, go forward, disable. Go, go,
Chow's,
go.
Chow's going forward, Chow's going forward.
Everyone else stay back.
Well, only one.
How do I know if I have pliers?
You have pink pliers over your head. They're big and they're green. They're big and they're pink. Okay, I got another green. Keep moving forward.
Moving up.
All the way forward, guys. Okay, I am going back down to find you a new droid. Good, good, good. Going to find you the next droid, buddy. Got him. Alright, rinse, repeat.
Got it. Someone used to
come. That's a second clear.
And enabling someone with pliers. One person with pliers. One.
Person, call it before. Call it before. Before.
You need to communicate, guys.
Reinforcements deploy.
Telepathy.
Move forward.
Activate.
Got you another green.
Good job.
No, I'm getting a lot of luck here. That is way more like lucky, happy greens than I ever get. Going to find another droid. Got him. Sending you another droid. I basically run around with a weird scanner trying to find that droid. He's hidden in blue. It's very strange, the mechanics of this fight.
That's a fun one.
It is! It's just very strange. Alright. Making it yellow. One.
Shell's going forward.
Thank
Shell's
you, Shell.
Going forward.
Good.
Reinforcements deploy! Reinforcements
Clear.
Deploy!
Can I run get your box now?
No, there's one more.
Okay.
It's red. Finding the last. Yeah, I've messed that up so many times. Ooh, he's right on you. Get ready for him.
Engage defensive systems.
Yeah, there's one extra row there that is fucking me up.
It looks like it would be over, right?
Right? Yeah. Oh, I'm so glad that's not just me. Like, seriously, I've died to that at least twice.
No.
God first interrupt.
Down. I've got pliers, I'll go. Unless someone else wants
it's
to go.
Yellow.
Going. Chow's going.
I'll get the box for Moxie.
Moxie's box.
Wow. Guys, volunteering for my box. It's been a while.
That was teed up on a silver platter with a doily, man.
Get her chicken Caesar salad first, man.
Aye. And then if you do good, you get the special dressing.
You spend more than $1.80 on it.
You're gonna take me out
from
for dinner
downtown,
first?
Grand Accord.
Right.
Downtown, Grand. Well done.
I mocked your turret for you.
Thank you
right.
So much. Much appreciated. And everyone, perfect. Good job. Really good, guys. I'm much better at
every
explaining
now and then
that
we get a clue.
Okay, kill everything but the one with the heal symbol, please.
The masters have decreed this end.
Kill turrets. Perfect. And just burn Mr. Vorgath. See, I think I'm just much better at explaining this one than the last fight. I need to, work on my explanation of Stormbringer and Firecrawler.
That was a complicated dance.
Well, and I've never healed it. I know most of it. You'll note here, occasionally a person gets a red debuff on them, just run it away from the group. Torlemaine saw that he was already in a great spot and just did that. Finish off the last turret.
Kill it with fire.
Or bullets. Yep. Or fiery bullets.
Traced around.
Alrighty, everyone grab your shinies. Good job. Any questions about that fight?
much less frustrating than those two tanks.
Yes, but you see why it's really, really important that when all the pliers pop up, one person goes, I got it. That's all you need, is I got it. And that person then runs to... Once the next square is yellow, then they go dismantle the bomb. All right, hit the button to come through to the next area. Hang to the right. You're going to die of shock. There's a shit ton more trash.
We thought we'd lost you. Good to see you back on the grid. See if you can flank Kephas' camp.
I'm not going to flank it. I'm going to march into it and destroy everything.
Bah.
That's what I do. With the crashing.
No creative trying to bypass shit.
Nope, we don't have enough stealth. We are going to jump into the middle and pew pew.
You want cannoneers first?
Yes, please. Note that there are two cannoneers. And don't stand in red.
Somebody take aggro off this other cannoneer.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me drop one of my...
There he goes.
There. That'll help.
Thank you.
I'll make him stop stealthing out on you. That's my contribution. I can occasionally remember to use stealth scan.
I never use it on my PT. I need to.
Merlin gave me so much shit about it a couple weeks ago, and I'm like, God damn it, you're so right. Like, she was like hardcore in defensive stealth scan. Like, I never use it. And she's like, well, here's where you should, and here's where you should, and here's where you should. And I'm like, yes, ma'am.
I've learned my lesson.
Yep. All right. Please don't try and jump along the right. You will die. There's just going to be a bunch of crap. Just start cleaning. Battlemaster is our core dude here. We're going to try and group everything to him as much as possible. I will yank things in as possible. As possible.
Thought really? You were about to start singing popular.
No. I was going way older than that. The version of Cinderella with Brandy.
Oh, 90s.
It's
with Whitney Houston.
Yeah, for a plain country bumpkin and a prince to fall in love. Come on, I'm not gonna go full Wicked on you guys. It's popular. I do love Wicked though. Okay, mount up, and we are going to hug the left wall this time. There's going to be another big one of those spider droids, and it's going to look like he's too close for comfort. He's not. He, for some reason, has the smallest hitbox. It's kind of magical. So as long as you hug the wall real tight, you will be just fine, and then sneak on ups. And we're going to grab those cannoneers against the wall first. See? Good job. Isn't that one really bizarre? Like, all the other things in this entire op, like, I feel like their hitboxes are bigger than I would expect. That one guy, no, he is just distracted.
Yeah, performance anxiety and had a small hitbox.
I'm just saying he went to the cantina before the op, you know? Like, he's a little hungover tonight. He's not paying attention. Oh, I totally finished reading Phasma today. It was fun. Someone nailed it, though, in their description. It's literally Mad Max. What are you apologizing for?
I hit the wrong button and I rescued you instead of cleansing you.
I was wondering why I jumped back.
Yeah, that was me.
Just toying with my heart, Kevin. I see how it is. Yanking me around.
Her a force wedgie.
Thankfully.
Checking out her fish tail, man, or whale tail.
Shh.
She's like, I'm not wearing any drawers.
Moxie!
I did not say that! That was said! Hey, okay.
Pants are required, underwear is optional.
I'm wearing both.
Well, that is Thank a loophole you never cleared up.
That's very true. Well, maybe all this time when I said pants, I was referring to underpants, and you guys were just misinterpreting. Anywho. Yeah.
No, that means you're in cahoots with those underpants gnomes. You get kickback money.
Hell yeah. Alrighty. So this fight is actually a fucking blast, and I love it. So we're going to start with Shal on shield. He's going to be poking that dude over there. Everyone else is going to hit target. I am going to taunt target, but then I'm going to move back and hang out with Fifi and tank Fifi. Again, just like the guys earlier, you want to interrupt. So who has first interrupt on target?
I can get first.
Perfect. Lightbane's got first. Gren, I nominate you for second. Okay. Sounds good. Everyone's going to kill target, kill Fifi, kill shield. After that, a bombardier is going to appear, and we are going to big bada pew pew him. That said, we want to kind of bring him over close to the droid, so or the big the battle walker in the middle. So Shal or me, whoever has him taunted, just try and bring him conveniently close. Whoever gets that final kill shot on the bombardier will, in fact, set us up the bomb. You'll get a little symbol over your head, just like my fancy tiara, and you will then run under the battle walker. There will be a tiny, tiny, and I mean tiny, tiny, red reticle under the battle walker. You will run onto it and stand on it, and you'll get yanked up into the battle walker, pull a Luke on us, bring it on down. We go big pew pew on the battle walker. Pew pew. Very fun. After that, we're going... I said reticle. I did not mean rectangle.
Giggity.
Thank you, Kevin. Okay, so after we pew-pew the walker, we're going to go through three rounds of groups of ads. The first one is going to appear over here. So make sure you... God, you got me all off my... You can't ruin my pace, man.
They're all hot and bothered.
Just distracted. kill the warrior. Okay, so you have to be under the shield to do damage. Again, no AoE. Kill the warrior first. That brings down the shield. Then you can AoE to your heart's content to kill all the rest of them. The next group will appear right where we're standing. Rinse, repeat. Kill the warrior first. Then kill all the rest. The third group will be over there. Rinse, repeat. Then there's going to be another bombardier. Same dealio with pew pew him. Whoever has the reticle, or who has the bomb, runs to the red reticle, pew pews up. Then two big droids are going to appear. One's going to be over here, and one's going to be over here. They cast this huge purple circle around them. Don't stand in it. You will die. So we are going to go back and forth between the two, pew-pewing as much as possible until they're both dead. After that, Milord Kephis finally deigns to join us. So actually, he'll probably come down a little earlier. Shalurai will pick him up and keep him out of the way. He will jump up into the air and then come back down. There'll be a big red circle on the ground where he's going to land. Pro tip, don't stand in it. The other thing is, when he comes back down to Earth, he drops aggro. So whoever had him before, unless their taunt is up again, whatever, that's usually when you do the tank swap. Then he'll cast this huge, huge purple circle of doom. And I mean 99% of this room. Hide in the corner as much as possible. Tuck out of that purple circle. And then you won't die, and then we win. That is pretty much it. Questions, concerns, love letters.
What's the name of the ability that interrupt?
I don't know. It's just the first thing he casts.
Okay, cool. The
siege droids go down really quickly too.
Awesome.
Yep. Just interrupt, because you're also all four DPS are on the same target there, so you can be redundant. Department of Redundancy Department. How may we be of service? So make sure you interrupt that dude.
Question about the groups of ads that spawn after the
yes.
droids are all down.
Uh-huh.
You said the warrior is the primary target.
Correct.
In the groups of ads?
Yep.
And what happens if you accidentally hit the extras?
That doesn't matter, but don't AoE.
Okay.
It'll bounce.
Ouch. Okay, take it off.
Single target first, then AoE.
Single target the warrior, then that takes down the shield, and then you AoE everyone else.
You'll know if you mess it up, because you'll be dead.
Pretty much.
It is very, very true. Okay, and great questions, guys. Any other questions? Cool. Throwing out a ready check. Board is green. Pulling in 3, 2, 1.
I did not interrupt that. That was too fast.
That's fine. Then someone else. Everyone should be on target. Perfect. And everyone now on Fifi? Interrupt. Perfect. All right, let's go group up on shield and finish off shield. We want to group up because that helps us know where the bombardier is. Keep it close. I got that interrupt. All right, there's our bombardier. We're going to drag him over to play with us cool kids back here because we always want him as close as possible. And whoever gets that kill shot is going to get the bomb. Tilwyn! Have fun! Nice! Perfect! Textbook perfect. Alright, everyone big PP on the Battlewalker. All right, here's our first group. Grab that warrior. The hell? There we go. Now you can AoE to your heart's content. Perfect. Now to the door. It's where the next ones are going to be. These actually come pretty slowly in story mode. But we know where they're going to be. They're always in the same spot. That's kind of nice. So we got that going for us. Hey, just as I said. And there's the warrior. If you want to target of target me, if that makes your life easier. And he's dead. AoE up. What?
Yeah. Nope. And he's dead.
Yeah.
He's here and now he's not.
Don't run into the Fifi, the exploding Battlewalker shit. Totally avoidable. It's kind of slow. We're going to run over to where the next group is going to be. Hey, look, here they are. Here's our warrior. And everyone else. Perfect. And there's our next bombardier. I'm gonna yank him closer. Yoink. I like my harpoon.
Times.
A harpoon for my next romantic interest.
Got it. Granny Corey.
Go, Grand.
You can do it!
You got it!
There you
got
it.
Freaking Luke Skywalker.
There we go. Okay, big pew pew. Well, I mean, now that we know Gren's related to Belthal, I'm sorry, my mind's blown.
Gren's related to Belthal?
They're brothers!
You were saying Torlemain in Belfal, and
no!
I was like, what?
No! Okay, I've got Kephis, everyone on the power droid that's not purple. Everyone on the power droid that's not surrounded in purple. Don't worry about Kephis, I'm just going to be kiting him around. He's up, shall pick him up when he comes back down. And run over to the other power droid. Don't get caught in that purple.
Do I want him bring him over to the other power one for AoE or just...
Yeah, yes, please.
Okay, cool.
Yep. Yarp.
Yarpy derpy.
Everyone back to that first power droid? for 3% of doom. Nice. Now you can poke at Kephis a little if you like. He's going to jump back down and I'll grab him.
Cool.
Got him. Everyone back to that other battle droid. Perfect. Now all your love on Mr. Kephis.
Beat him like he stole something.
He might have.
I mean, do you think he got those battle walkers legally? I'm a little skeptical.
I don't.
He doesn't strike me as the guy. Everyone out of the circle, run, and like far out of the circle. Like, don't be on the edge. I have died by being on the edge. Edging, not my thing. Anywho. You know,
there's the thirsty Thursday.
Yep, I had to make up for Tuesday.
Tuesday was a very tame Tuesday.
It was.
For doing TFB too.
Do you know how hard I was biting my tongue during so much of that? It's rough. Raid wides, please.
You type puns on PG-13 night. What the hell?
I know. It just. Let's write. We need to write a letter to BioWare. Like, can you please only have TFB on Thursdays? Anywho, really good job, everyone. That Kephis fight, kind of fun, right? I always dig it. Any questions about the process?
It's way easier on story mode.
Oh, yeah, I mean, yes, it is, in fact. If you had not, if this was your first time in here and you had that one-time story, this is where, you are going to exit area and turn that in. Oh no, it's gonna blow up, we're all gonna die!
Not Ravagers again.
Close. No.
Bit different.
You don't get kicked out. You don't get kicked out. You just stand around and shit keeps blowing up. All right. Does anyone need to leave? We still have 30. I was hoping we'd do Eyeless, but just a quick check. No, Shell. Eyeless. Then TC.
You're actually skipping her pony.
Or do you want me to switch over to DPS? We don't need two tanks for Eyeless, do we?
As long as that DPS can log as a tank for us to group finder there.
It's a skank on.
Can anyone mark as a tank so that we can group finder?
I can mark. I can mark as a tank with my Vanguard.
Okay, then perfect. Whoever else needs to leave and switch, you do it. I really need to go pee. I'll be back in 5 seconds.
Thank you for sharing.
If everything comes out right.
Dude, hour and a half is my limit.
How the hell did you watch Lord of the Rings? You're doing being a 5-year-old doing that. I got a pee dance.
I didn't drink alcohol back then.
Okay, gotcha.
And that movie is crazy long. I think anyone couldn't last through that. 12
yeah,
and a half
I think,
hours.
I think I still did take a break.
Train your bladder.
So, Gren, you and Belthor are brothers?
Yeah. Trying not to ruin his good reputation.
I was going to say, I love that they're both reticent to admit it.
I don't think you're ruining it at all.
He's had a lot more time over the past couple of years to play Star Wars, so I'm playing catch up.
Oh, and you know there's a website actually called runp.com, and it tells you for any movie, like, where the slowest point is and, like, the most highly recommended point to go dodge and run pee.
That is awesome.
It is the greatest thing ever for people like me with a bladder the size of a walnut. I can plan ahead.
I can't blame that pragmatism. That's a good call to make.
You know, with this... Oh, I'm sorry. We're a group finder joined group, so everyone needs to disband, and I need to regroup everyone.
Sorry, the potato is still loading.
No!
I'll be done loading soon.
All good. Now I have shall group convert to an ops group. Now I can grab everyone next up when you get in. Yes, run P is highly recommended by me for, yes, everyone. Especially for things like Lord of the Rings, where you know you're going to be in that chair for the better part of 4 hours.
Yeah, once COVID is done, that sounds like a useful site for my wife.
Exactly. I mean, if not for you, for those you love.
That's fair.
Do we have a minion going out to Eyeless?
I'll be able to group find or summon us out there. I just need everyone to X up in chat. I'm still missing 3.
Excellent. I can be lazy and sit here.
Yeah, everyone can be lazy. Check your bags in the meantime.
Get your vaccines.
Yes, that's the other thing. Stop by a med droid and make sure you have Rakul vaccine.
Yep. Don't be choosy. Pfizer or Moderna. Just get your shots and go.
Yarp. I'm seeing Grenicor is already in a group.
Yeah, sorry.
Silly rabbit.
What did you do while I was gone? You went and joined a whole new team?
Met up with sketchy strangers on fleet.
I'm hurt, man.
I'll be out of the group soon.
Had to do a quick drug drop.
Apparently. Holding it for a friend, were we?
Damn. No, 420 was 2 days ago, guys. Come on.
Oh, I missed it.
Yeah, today's Earth Day, isn't it?
It is Earth Day. Today is Earth Day. Yes. I definitely took a trash bag and gloves when I walked Ava. Okay.
I'm looking for a medical droid.
I have some extra. I only have 6. Yeah, any droid is gonna have it. But on the ship, it'll be like, or on fleet rather, it'll be front and center. So everyone make sure you have a couple. They do get cleaned off of you. Has anyone not done Eyeless?
I think I've only done it once.
Okay. It's really straightforward.
Big rat ghoul with a massive butt crack.
You really like his butt. I'm just throwing it
out there. No.
Charlemagne has a thing for Eyeless's ass.
It's coming from the woman so much poking with the Trisha references.
Uh-huh.
This is a judgment-free zone.
He likes that big Eyeless badonkadonk.
We need to support that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Be a beautiful thing. I don't know.
Aww. Is everyone ready?
I'm still looking for a medical drawer.
Does someone have that
quest? Honestly,
I don't know.
I'm at one. If you can see me on the press tab, I'm right at one. Darkbane.
Okay, come on.
For the solidarity jump.
Yes, on the east side of the central circle.
Thank you. You can tell I spend a whole lot of time on the Republic side.
Stand by for examination and suggested products.
I always wonder about those suggested products.
You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Like, is he going to suggest a nose job?
That still reminds me of Mr. Garrison getting his rhinoplasty. Turning into the Hoff.
Alrighty.
Everyone good?
Okay. Now, please, in Group Finder, make sure... Your activity finder, make sure your role is correct. I do need one other person as tank.
Oh, yeah. Tank already.
Your COVID vaccine to a spot on your taskbar, too.
Yes. That is, again, very important. Put those Rakul vaccines somewhere available and accessible. Okay.
Those little bastards would like to bite you.
I am showing us as cannot queue. I have a conflicting phase. Let me... Reset all lockdown operations. And now we're good. Okay. Pulling in 3. Off we go. Alright. So, Mr. Eyeless, big ugly dude, standing in the middle of his little cave. And we come in and fuck him up because we're kind of assholes that way. It's going to start out with groups of ads around the edge. We are going to grab them up, kill them one by one, hugging the edge in a clockwise fashion. They will stun whoever grabs them first, so I will jump in and poke first, and then I'm sorry. Ah!
Angry Johnny.
Angry... No. Johnny is not tank. Who's my new tank?
I can tank.
Oh, I'm sorry. You are there. It's just my raid frames are mucked. There we go. Because I didn't fix them yet. Yay.
Ah,
and there's Cheeky, and there's Astracella. And now we're good. Okay, now the raid frames are fixed. Okay, and guarding... Oh, Kevin's not in yet.
Sorry, still loading.
Potato.
Speaking of spoilers, I found a good trick for Radeon video cards. Or not Radeon, AMD. If you overclock them but force them to always use maximum speed, then it doesn't keep cycling up and down.
Yeah. Like before AMD
pops. And then they light on fire.
Well, you have to have good cooling.
AMDs overheat.
The new ones actually don't.
Okay, I'm in.
Anywho, yes, I have you guarded, Kevin. And Shal, if you would be so kind as to guard Cheeky. So anyway, we're going to kill the ads, hugging the wall around in a clockwise fashion, and then I will grab Mr. Bossman. I will have him facing a wall as tightly as possible, because he does a conal big smash on me. Everyone else, tight, tight, tight. Like, group up like your absolute best friends standing on top of each other behind him. Because he's going to drop green circles. If you're all together, we know where that green circle drops. And they aren't going to be scattered all over the fucking floor. Okay. So it really, really helps. I will be scooching him around the edge to make sure everyone has plenty of space so that you aren't stacked on those green circles. But again, every time we move, tight, tight, tight. I don't care if you're ranged. I don't care if you're a healer. I don't care if you're distracted by a really cute raccoon in the corner. Oh, wait. That's the next thing. There are going to be ads. Try and group them all up and burn them down quick. Always prioritize the ads over Eyeless. Ads, don't stand in shit. Eyeless. The other big thing he'll do is a big purple circle. It goes smash. Even I can't stand in it. Everyone get out of the purple circle and then back to positions. Rinse, repeat. Stack, smash, pick off ads, nudge, nudge, nudge. So, shall mostly be trying to get those ads off the healers. I will be dancing with Eyeless, and otherwise, we'll be just fine. Questions, concerns, love letters. Eerie silence.
All good.
Eerie silence. I'll take eerie silence for 1,000, Alex.
Oh, you thought LeVar Burton's going to be a guest host.
Very true. That's kind of exciting. Now, make sure you put on your very first Rackle vaccine.
Circle, circle, dot, dot, cootie shot. Elementary school style.
Something like that. Pulling in three, two, one. And I'm stunned.
Same. It's for fun.
Told you that they like to bite you.
Yep. That's what I'm saying. All right. Rinse, repeat, around the left.
Second verse, same as the first.
And the third, and the fourth, and the fifth. I think there's only five, to be honest. But make sure you're hugging the wall. Don't accidentally nudge into Mr. Eyeless and start the fight, because then we'll just be sad. Very nice.
He spoke French.
Oh, Spanish.
And poo?
It was Spanish, but... We'll send you to not not.
Oh, French is like more sea bear cooter and stuff.
Je m'appelle Moxie. Est-ce que vous parlez le français? No, my French is so bad that in Paris they immediately start speaking to me in English. No joke.
Bless her heart, she don't know no better.
It's really
don't
bad.
Worry, all like, French people do that.
It's amazing. It's even when I apologize and I'm like, "Je suis American," and they're like, "Ah, yeah, yeah, American." Okay. I'm gonna pull them straight forward. Pulling in 3, 2.
Yeah, poor Bat. He gets mad at
you. Don't stand in the green. Everyone, group up on his tushy. Tight, tight, tight.
I like Eyeless.
Purple, out of the purple. And moving him over.
Ooh, that hurt.
Yeah.
Keeps that pimp hand strong.
It's almost like it's why I said don't stand in it, yeah? Ads are primary focus. And don't stand in that green. We're going to nudge him over. You don't want to be in front of him? Oh, God. Our greens are getting messy. Out of the perps. Group on up, guys. Otherwise, those greens go all the places instead of just some of the places. Okay, moving him. Moving him.
Cover the ads, guys.
Out of the perps.
Group up.
Moving off to the other side. Okay. Out of the perps. Ads. Moving out of the green. Out of the perps. Taking him 2 stops over. Good job grouping up, guys. And right whites. Nudging him a little back into the corner. Giving you a little more space out of the perps. Focus Eyeless, just Eyeless, big Eyeless. 4%. Ta-da! Congratulations. Ooh, symbiote. Oh,
we got. Ooh, we got a pet.
Kitten. I hope it's a pretty rare one too.
It is. Very nice.
And you got it too.
Squee!
Almost like she got
the little Mina's gonna be happy.
RNGesus loves
you. Have to find it in those bags. Holy cow.
I found it. I got him. He's seeing.
We will hug him and squeeze him and give him lots of love.
And call him Racky. we do still have 15 minutes because you guys did it.
What the hell? Let's go beat down a llama.
We should llama.
Just throwing it out there. All right, everyone exit area.
Chicken.
And do we have to reform again? This was group?
Yep. Yeah, because this is group finder. So quick group. I'm always hesitant to promise what we'll do after EC because it can take a lot longer like that. Or Ravagers or
Eternity Vault.
No.
That one time.
Just the one time. When it was
the Simon Says guy.
That was cursed. Okay. Everyone out, X up in chat. And I will reinvite.
Extra X there.
That's a lot of X. It's not Saturday night.
Dadgummit.
Triple Xing up is for OE evenings. Oh shit, I didn't change it to God damn it.
I'd be like, damn it, Beavis.
I was like, I swear I've invited you guys like 8 times over.
It's okay. We've all had learning repair moments.
I'm getting
I miss
old.
The boy. She's getting the subtitles.
Okay. Everyone's in. Additional commands. Phase. Reset all phase. Filter. Oh, make sure your roles are correct still. And
no D&D multiclassing.
Do I need to stay as tank for this, or should I do DPS?
Just DPS is great. Yeah, I'll tank cool. Mr. Llama.
But do I need to queue as a tank or DPS, or does it matter?
I need you queued as tank, but you can now. You can deep. Yeah.
Gotcha.
He likes your skanky side.
I like my off tanks a little on the skanky side.
Wow. Okay, and unlock raid frame. There we go. Locked and loaded. Guarded Kevin. Okay. Everyone in.
Assuming me and Grenicor will be on backfield ads.
S'il vous plaît. Yes, please.
Spanish.
Do that
now.
More, Seabird.
That
Seabird
was French.
I know.
All I heard was souffle.
You know why the French only have one egg for breakfast? Because one egg is enough.
That's there you go.
Ooh,
yes!
Martin, you reach Limburger status.
And that's your bad Moxie French joke for the evening. I only have the one, so trust me, you're good. Okay, pulling in 3, 2, 1.
That's why we're just considered bourgeois Americans.
Everyone out? Well, and it's funny, because now to be considered bougie in the U.S. is, like, a connotation of your fancy. The bourgeoisie.
Oh, back to Marie Antoinette, I gotcha.
Did you know that when she said, let them eat cake, cake is actually the black coating in the bottom of your oven?
Yeah, but that's That has to be explained in context, though.
That's why I explained it.
So many times it wasn't clarified. You're like, angel food cake. Damn, bitch, you fancy with the pinky extended.
She also had an entire fake village out behind Versailles that was a mini village. And depending on what color gown she wore that day, her servants would go paint the animals that color. So she would walk out and play peasant with her ladies' maids. And I've actually walked this area. It's beautiful. It's so gorgeous. You can take a bike tour and do the Palace of Versailles in a day. It's so cool. But yeah, her little fake village would be filled with all these animals, like, that were all pink or all blue or all yellow, depending on what.
I hope it was something like temper paint.
Really? Yep. In that day and age, do you really think they were thinking animal friendly?
No.
I was there. I would have cut your head off. Yeah.
Like, it was gonna be dinner in a couple days anyway, you know.
Lead poisoning or otherwise. Yeah.
Do you know the armistice of World War I was actually ended in the Palace of Versailles?
That's why it's called the Treaty of Versailles.
Exactly. It was signed in the Hall of Mirrors. The World War II was ended in Reims, just a couple hours outside.
But we learned not to have neighboring alliances for World War II.
They actually have a really cool museum there with, like, the table where they signed everything and uniforms of all the different countries. And then, you know, if you also are driving past all these beautiful vineyards next, because it is actually the Champagne country of France, but there's also these vineyards with all the signs of, like, yeah, there's still active shells out here, so don't jump the fence.
If your plow goes thunk on something, run away.
Just stay on the road, yeah? Stay on the road.
No, with farmers and stuff that find them a lot of times still.
It's really scary how many are still out there. 21, 20, can we do it? Yeah, we pushed raid wides and big pew pew.
Pepper put you real good.
Well done.
Push it. Push it real good. Dun, dun, dun,
dun, dun, dun. Yeah, boy.
I love you guys so much.
Nice.
What would I do without you? I would just be sitting here quietly playing alone or, like, reading quietly alone. I would not be giggling anywhere near this much. Okay, well, I think that was a perfect 2 hours. Oh,
that
see,
was a good three from Moxie.
If wishes were horses. Aw, Tabitha, thanks for the raid. Hope you had a good stream, Tabitha. All right, good times. That was pretty fucking epic, right?
Good.
And then, friendly warning, I am actually teaching, or not teaching, I guess, leading story mode tomorrow night as well. Machine is apparently doing, like, things with family. I don't know, this
gross.
Whole, like, people, you, yeah, I don't get it, but, you know, whatever.
He's earning brownie points with a significant other and stuff. God.
So, he also didn't tell me which operation, so I'll make up my mind somewhere between lunch and ops tomorrow. Sign up, come join me as I get really, really frustrated with it being a 16 man, because that'll be fun.
The control freak in you will be freaking.
Yeah. I don't do, there's a reason I don't do 16 mans. Iggy keeps asking me, like, hey, so what do you think about, like, doing a couple more 16 mans? I'm like, nope, I'm good. I'm really, you know, I got.
What about the crazy train pools, man?
I've got a crazy train right here. It's 7 people. It's fantastic. Just the right amount of crazy.
Paintable crazy. That's, yeah.
Quasi-man.
It's just what. It's the same thing we want for in dating. Just containable crazy. Something that you can do.
Right,
like,
right.
I see Moxie sitting on the couch and AD standing around behind her.
What was that?
There's a meme I have with Moxie sitting on the couch and 8 DPS standing behind her.
Thanks for the runs, guys. Yep. I'm going to go grab a bite.
Have a most wonderful evening, and thanks, everyone, for signing up, being on time, showing up ready to rock and roll. That was really good. There was definitely some learning there, so that's always a perk. And
patience and sense of humor are appreciated to get through knocking the rust off stages. So
right.
Yep. Thanks again, Moxie. Give your dog a good pet for us.
Will do. Thanks. Now that she's not in Trebs anymore.
Tell your friends. Thanks again. Have a good night.
See you guys soon. Right.
See you guys.
Tabitha, yes, my bags are a clusterfuck, but you have to remember, I just did back-to-back-to-back, EC, Eyeless, and TC. Guys, why are you judgmental of my bags? Ooh, I got an R2. You can be judgy all you want, I got an R2. Here, I will clean shit up, just so y'all can get off my case. Sheesh. Yes, but I was tanking, Tabitha. I did. I emptied them at multiple points throughout that. It was 2 straight hours of... Here you won't find anywhere else. Yeah. Especially when I'm also teaching and explaining, I don't get nearly as much time because I'm not focusing on me. I'm focusing on... everyone else, like, you're standing in green, or, you know, make sure you do X, Y, and Z. It's not just about me and my bags. I have enough baggage. I think we've all noticed. Thank you all for judging my baggage. I like it when they're tidy. I also know when things are out of my control. And, I don't know. There. Is that everything I got a couple more. There! All tidy, which is good because I am actually using this character again tomorrow. Thank you, Rob. Love you too. And I'm going to use this moment to just share out something really important. A dear, dear friend of mine I've known since I was 19. She was recently brutally attacked by her next door neighbor because of being trans by a really, really piece of shit neighbor. The person was released from custody the next day. Cash bail after shattering my friend's ocular bone, ruining facial construction she'd had as part of her transition, and causing her a shit ton of pain, damage, and general fear. And that is completely unacceptable. So my dear friend Chayna is on the fly, going to be moving very soon and very quickly. There is a link to her GoFundMe, as well as on my Moxie Twitch page. If you scroll down to the About, there's a link. I dearly, dearly love this person, and it breaks my fucking heart that she is in this horrid situation, that she has not been able to go home since this happened. She has been staying with friends, and I know I donated a chunk of money, and every little bit helps so that she doesn't have to extend the move, so that she can have movers come pack everything up and get her the fuck out ASAP. So she is... planning all of that very quickly, and this is a cause near and dear to my heart. Like I said, this is someone I dearly, dearly love, and you know, anything you can do to help would mean a lot, because I hope you all know it's really important to me that my gaming space be a safe gaming space for all people, and I've always been, it's really important to me to be very inclusive, and you know, I'm bi, and I know that her coming out as trans was really hard for her, and I just, if there's anything you can do to help, every little penny to help Chayna get out safely, there's my little grandstand for the day for a cause. I'm not, you know, this isn't a thing I do a lot, but this one really, really means a lot to me, so. I'm going to keep posting this over the next week or so. I've been really impressed by how much people have donated so far, and, like, they get it. This isn't a joke. This isn't... Yeah, exactly, Tabitha. It's really scary. I mean, the pictures are horrific. I was sobbing incoherently when she first told me. It's not okay. There's cruelty, there's stupidity, and then there's the system being so broken that she is not safe, and this is not acceptable. So, again, Thank you. Okay, happy Star Wars noises. We're gonna... Yeah. Yeah. She and I fenced together in college. Good times. I kicked her ass. Back when she was he. yeah, a not okay is a like understatement of the year. So, you know, every little thing we can do to help return some semblance of normalcy. I mean, this is a person who is an amazing engineer. Her current company, she builds robotic devices for amputee prosthetics. It's so cool. I mean, she's one of the most brilliant creative people I know. Epic photographer. Just all around good person. So it was, it's just horrific. I can't imagine having to deal with that kind of thing ever in your day-to-day life. Being afraid to go home. You know, I've had some shit relationships in my life, but god damn it, nothing like that. I mean, so. Yeah. Hope you're all doing well tonight. Yeah.
If you find a better deal somewhere else, well, go away.
Sure, Kai, sure. Actually, I wonder what Kai Zenkin is selling. He did reset today. It is Thursday. Oh, look, it's a party with Kai. I cannot interact. All right.
Great timing.
Let's see. Welcome. Anything good? Oh, you got some biochem schematics for a tactical. Oh, grit teeth. So, yeah, if you have a biochem, buy the schematic, make it. It's going to cost a shit ton in mats, but you can make bank selling these on the GTN. Highly, like, 10 out of 10 recommend if you have a biochem to grab this schematic here. Synth weaving, those always sell really well too. Let me turn off my particular. Nope. Yep, that's the only, like, this is the one I'm going to shout out, is make sure you get that if you have a biochemist.
Hey, tell all your friends about me.
I just did, Kai. I just did. What more do you want? I told all my friends about you, man. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Okay. So let's see, is everything here mostly tidy? Mostly. Let's see if anything needs that armoring. I don't think they are. Ooh. Nope, not gonna be worth it. We're good. Okay, so we'll deconstruct the rest of that crap. And... I know, right, Ron? He tries. Every week he tries. He tries, but he ain't getting my money this week because, A, this isn't a biochemist, and I just don't need the other gear. She's got her proper set gear. I mean, I worked really hard to make sure she's got all of her right price kitted out just so. She is nice and tanky. Actually, I had someone ask, like, well, what kind of tank is your Vanguard? And I'm like, the tanky kind of tank. I like to have enough defense that I'm not making my healers work far too hard for me. Okay, what's that? Yeah, I still have the vaccine on me. That's good. Okay, and now we can tuck her away. Oops, that is so not what I meant to do. I'm a little tired. That was a full work day. Okay, that's where I want to go. Back to the Schwartz. And I do have to pick what operation I'm going to lead tomorrow. Let's see if anyone's signed up yet. That's always exciting. For anyone who's interested, I am in the Guild RAIA. You should go check out our guild website. We're kind of fucking awesome. You grabbed my stats at the start. Oh, no. Don't use me as your Vesperin shit. No. Get Iggy. Iggy, when I got into tanking. So, true story. I have never been a big, like, tank person. I realized it was going to be the best way for me to be able to lead and be like a meaningful leader in these story mode ops. It's just really hard to lead from behind, I have noticed. Plus, there's never enough healers, or never enough tanks. So I got into it, and I kind of figured, ooh, good, we already have 5 people. That's nice. Realized I dug it, and he, like, Iggy, by the way, is our guild leader. He sat me down. I got like an hour one-on-one lecture of best practices. It was very cool. Hey, Eowyn, welcome! Welcome to Moxieland. The drinks are strong and the girls are pretty, and I am not biased at all about the latter. We are having a most wonderful evening. I just finished teaching Explosive Conflict, Eyeless, and Tomorrow's Courtyard back to back to back. Whew! Okay, she is all repaired. We can tuck her in. What? That was funny. That it gave me the active face warning. Like, no, I'm alone. I promise, I'm not even in a group anymore. And speaking of pretty things and tanks, I think I'm gonna keep working away on my Movit tonight. He is up to 71. I'm actually really excited to have an assassin tank, just because they're so different. I just go back and forth between my Vanguard and her perfect mirror, my shield tech, power tech. So they just share all the gear and the exact same layouts of key bindings and all that jam. Ooh! He... Nice. Punch, cough, punch, cough, punch, cough. Warning for anyone who hasn't done Knights of the Fallen Empire, we are in Spoilerland. Instead of the spice will flow, whoa, the spoilers will flow.
The power core, Fat Fingers.
That's Captain Fat Fingers.
You are not Captain, it is my ship, and fuck you, Koth. Yes, Respirin, and this is a fuck Koth land. We hate Koth. Like, a lot. No.
You will not modify this vessel without my permission.
I love Movit's voice. I'm compiling a list. Yay! Tabitha's one of us! Team Fuck Koth!
Focus on the hyperdrive first.
Acceptable. For now.
Alright, I need to grab a quick drink.
Shh. Your lack of intelligence is insulting.
Let's give them space. That bridge can only hold so many personalities.
I'm used to it.
I imagine so, given your previous companions. Scorpio worked with Imperial Intelligence in the past, but now she operates independently. Thoughts?
I have many thoughts, Lana. But when I'm with you, they aren't about Scorpio. Sorry, pouring my drink. I'll be right back. God, I love having a wireless headset. Best money ever. And I was actually very flattered. One of my coworkers said the other day, just like completely interrupted me during a work meeting of, you know, Moxie, your voice is so clear. Like, I haven't had, of all these Zoom calls and everything we've been taking, I've never had anyone I could hear so clearly. I'm like, well, if you want to go spend $330 on a very nice gaming headset. She's like, no, I'm good. All right. Keep a close eye on her.
We'll give her the benefit of the doubt, but not the run.
I'm with you, Tabitha. I went through... Thank you. Well, no, so the Lana in my chair was based on a vote, because I used to have a full screen, like, Moxie, you'll be right back, Lana's piloting, and people didn't like that, and they liked the chair, and then there was a running joke about my chair, because I would leave, and one of my dear friends was like, oh, hello, chair, and I busted up in a giggle fit for, like, 15 fucking minutes, like, seriously, I couldn't talk, I was so delighted, so, yes, My best girlfriend, Mina, who is also dealing with a move right now, actually had a cup made for me back when I was super, super in love with Theron. It says Moxie and Theron. Oh, my God. And she's actually having a Lana one made for me right now. So I'm so excited that I can have my matching Lana and Theron cups. but I decided, you know, rather than falling in love with Theron, I created my own boy toy here. So I have Lana and my Mavit, and that's all I need in my brain pan. Right? We need more Lana merch. So apparently, we're just making it.
We can only defeat Arkham by working together.
We've a long road ahead, but at
Lana
Benike
approves. I want Lana's approval.
Your presence is requested. Come along.
So I actually started this character because I was writing a fanfic for my main Sith assassin chick, and I wanted her to have a love interest who wasn't Theron, and I decided I needed to just write my own. So I created this guy, and then I just epically fell in love with his everything about his character, and I've been having way too much fun. So thus came Mavit into my world. His actual name is Darian, but Darth Mavit.
I've got you to rescue me. What more could I need?
I'm serious. If anything happens to you...
Then you'd better kiss me. Just to be safe.
You're insufferable.
I know. I am.
Oh, yeah! I'll be in my bunk.
This isn't the time or place. 1 hour. If I don't hear from you, I'll rip that sanctuary apart.
That was perfection. They looked so good together. Oh my god. Yeah. Do we all need a little bunk time after that? That was, pretty intense. Kevin? No. In my little world, T3 might just be recording. He'd be making the sex tape. He's not a participant, but yeah, he can watch. All right. Now I just have to kind of, you know, remember how to play this character. I vaguely think I know what I'm doing. He's not participating. I mean, there'll be some like beep beep whoop in the corner. Lana's intense. I love it. Ooh, Tabitha. I love where your brain's at, girl. Speaking of overfull bags. Now you guys have me paranoid about my bags. I feel so judged about my baggage. And I'm one to gladly admit, like, I got more baggage than, more issues than Vogue, but, ow. What's all this about? Yay! Little thumbs up with a lighter from the corner? Hell yeah. He'd be cheering us on. That was... Oh, cell junk. What more do we have? Mission experience boost. Oh, I don't even have one on. Phew. Good call, Bioware. Helping me get to 75. I'm so undergeared here. I mean, Tabitha by our age, like, who doesn't, right? Some skulls are thicker than others. Oh, I was telling you guys about this the other day. Remember when I was playing and it was the two the Zakulian knights who were attacking me, and I told you they were two men, but they were together, and no one believed me? This is the letter. It was the two guys. Some skulls are thicker than others. I didn't exactly enjoy being knocked out cold today, but I took it as a learning opportunity. My partner, well, he's on the thicker side. You could have killed us outright if you're everything he says you are. You would have dumped our corpses in a ditch. He'll come around someday. I'll work on it. Thanks for letting me go home to my husband tonight. See? Told you. I was like, oh, these are the awesome gay guys. No one believed me. Uh-huh. The gays are cool and nice. It's a cool, ahead of the curve, inclusive. Seriously, like five people are like, no, those two guys, no, they're just, and I remembered that note. It made an impression on me. I like that kind of thing. I like options. Never heard of it. It's like, it really bothers me that my Vanguard couldn't romance Dorne. My Vanguard chick is like super gay, and she would look amazing with Dorne. I love Dorne, by the way. Dorne is my kind of girl. She's a play by the rules, serious business, but you know she's the kind that, like, once she drops her her guard, she's kinky as fuck. My kind of girl. I tie with them, and that's not enough for me. I want it all. Whereas on my male Vanguard, they got married and were super cute, and she's like, I'll file all the paperwork and everything. I'm like, oh, I wanted that for my female Vanguard, too. Because she's not marrying the cat. Cheers to that, girl.
Heskel.
I want it all. And I want it now. Oh, fucking Heskel. Right? We're on the same page, Tabitha. We are so on the same page there.
I don't need
Dorne, I just...
anyone be honored.
You followed me.
I was invited. Heskel arranged all of this. The fool.
Remind me to not have him be my wedding planner, because he sucks at it.
If you wanted a fight, we wouldn't be talking.
I have the imagination to see many solutions to a dilemma. Unlike your friend, Scions have always worshipped at the false altar of fate. That is why I kill them.
Well, that's good, Rob.
Prophecy. I forge my own destiny by making the hard choices. Now it's your turn.
I love seeing all the different options.
I'm not without mercy. Surrender. You will be returned to Carbonite until I find a way to rid you of my father.
And the others.
Hard pass on Carbonite.
Free to leave. Without the gravestone, of course.
Bullshit.
It belongs to the Eternal Throne. You understand.
Fear of Sorry, Erkin. I call bullshit. Himself a
dragon. My son will betray.
No shit, Sherlock. Tell me something I don't know.
Busy man. Don't make me wait.
I'll have all my female characters marry Theron once they get... Yeah, but... God damn that betrayal. Ugh, it stings, man. Can't there be one male, like, decent male in this game who doesn't betray you?
Wouldn't dream of it.
Come.
They all have such massive chips on their shoulders, too. Alright.
Aha! You are weak.
Well, yes, I'm only level 71, man. And not geared, so yes, I'm weak. And I haven't established my rotation on this character yet. I was waiting until I'm 75 to do that. I mean, I know a lot of it, like it's familiar because of my DPS and... But it's different. It's not the same. Taurian! See, I can't do Taurian or Mako because they feel so young to me. They feel like kid brother, kid sister. They just, I can't. I get the heebie-jeebies about it. Maybe it's because I'm old. I don't know. They feel like they're 17 or 18. Oh, well, okay, fair enough. That makes sense, Tabitha. Rob says, my male commando has... Uh-oh. Awen, thank you so much for the gift sub. Dude, my heart. Thank you. Huge shout out. Much appreciate. Oh my god, guys. Welcome, Wolfman. Hope you're having a good one. Woo!
Any
Welcome to Moxieland.
Improvement is always a priority. Activating firing pattern.
I like Mako. I don't love her. Exactly! She's Kit's sister. She's... like, I just want to grab her and a hug and give her a noogie.
I take it all back. That's some good shooting.
Thank you so much. Good to see you.
Someone better check up on our Outlander.
No, no Wolfmen. There aren't a lot of us, but we're a pretty small, tightly knit team. So I actually interact with a lot of the other SWTOR streamers. Marcus is wonderful. He just got like 500 follows recently. SWTORista is, of course, ass kicking. If you look down, my little bit symbol is the red lips that SWTORista made that for me. Yep. Marcus is actually celebrating his 1 year streamiversary tomorrow. So I'm actually going to be taking some story mode ops with him. He made me promise. I was actually on his 101st episode of his podcast with Working Class Nerds. You should check it out. It was pretty fucking fun. Let's see. Kitty Kisses is absolutely fantastic. Big ol' fan of him. He is just a hoot and just like the nicest guy ever. I actually sent him a full Jedi costume that was my ex-husband's. I was like, you know, I have 4 pounds of a Jedi costume sitting around taking up space and I'm never going to bother to tailor them down to my size. And he's like, oh, well, how much do you want for them? I'm like, I didn't offer to sell them to you. I offered to give them to you. So I just shipped them on up and they look amazing on him. He looks so badass. I love it. He is the nicest guy. Let's see. Yeah, I just, Tabitha here is one of the newer streamers. She is fantastic, fun to watch. We're just, you know, everyone, Sith Lord Brit does a lot of cool stuff. I also like watching her make things. That was really cool. I just, the whole SWTOR streaming community, everyone's like really supportive and helpful of each other. Oh, SWTOR Merlin. I'm sure you've seen the Merlin guides out there. They're like the gold star for story mode ops. She pops in here a lot and like she's the one I was talking about earlier is yelling at me about not using my seeking droid thingy enough. Not seeking droid. Shit. The one that reveals the hidden guys on my Vanguard. You know what I'm talking about. Oh, I love Merlin. So she always makes me laugh and like wop, 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 wop. Yeah. Oh, Kogus. Oh my god. Kogus is, he's a bigger flirt than I am, and that's saying something. Holy fuck. Love him. I got hooked the very first time I watched his stream. He was doing one of his pull-up streams, and I'm like, tasty. I'm good. Star Wars and a cute guy doing pull-ups. Like, I'm good. Like, this is a nice way to spend my evening. But yeah, well put, Dark Light. Like, we're all so supportive of each other. Like, it's not... There's no competition or hate. It's just everyone... Exactly. We're all boosting each other. We all throw each other raids and try and make it fun for everyone. Because it's the whole point, right?
Alive? Yes. Intact? Mostly.
The gravestone is under siege.
I'll lick it and make it better, Mobbit. If it's broken, I'll lick it and make it better.
Hold tight. I'm coming.
I'll hold you tight. Different parts of you, different levels of tightness. Well, and you guys all make this so much fun for me, too. I love your interaction when I get to play, and it just... I mean, one of the reasons I... sneaks mode. Doink! Can't see me. No one here, just a smuvit. Just a smuvit. Sneak on through. I know, Wolf, right? Mobbit is one pretty, pretty piece of Jedi. Or Sith, rather. He is, well, we've determined he is, lawful evil. He is. I adore my Darth Mobbit. Darian. Ooh! Ah! None of that. Nope. I was sneaks, and you can't see me, and you fuck off now. God, didn't they know I was sneaks in there? I don't want to play. I'm just sneaksing on through. I love my sneaksy characters. Now I feel like I have the best of both worlds with this guy because I'm a tank and a sneaks. I have everything I ever wanted. And she's, you know, cute to look at. My friend Mina, who's my usual moderator, who's away this week because she's dealing with IRL drama and, you know, moving and all that shit. She actually got this outfit for me and I'm just like, uh-huh. Yeah, that'll do. That'll do. I mean, the first time she showed it to me, I think I was just stunned of just like, yeah, this'll work. or not. How about I just kill you instead? Boom. And not stand in your conal. Rule number one, don't stand in stupid. Kevin has returned to us. Yay! Astracella is my other awesome moderator. He is also in my guild, RAIA, and he was healing my sorry ass earlier when I poorly described Stormcaller and Firebrand. I need to learn to explain that fight better. I did a very poor job, which is really annoying, because most of them now I have, like, down pat that I can teach them in a heartbeat without, like, overthinking it. That one caught me a little bit. Thanks, Kevin. I appreciate your lurks. Did a Koga sneak in? Ah, wild Koga's appeared!
You did bring
him. Oh, bye, Tabitha! Necessary. Kogus, how's your evening, my dear? When it is their time to die. Love you, Tabitha. See you soon.
None of this was necessary. Asylum's people are dying because of you.
Thousands weighed against trillions. Whew. They perish. So the galaxy...
Kogus, what have you been up to, my man?
I have no regrets.
I'm up to doing sets of 16 push-ups. Look at these tiny little things. Rawr. Yeah! So, I did 4 sets of 15 yesterday, so I'm up to 60 fucking push-ups a day, minimum. Like, and oddly enough, the 16... today was just as hard as the 3 on the very first day. So we're, you know, it's like continuous upward progress. It's so cool.
You doomed asylum for
getting
a fantasy.
Strong.
Your vision of hallucinations of a madman.
Gonna get that summer body. No, yesterday I had life. Unfortunately, I saw your post though. You were gonna do like pull-ups and push-ups and all sorts of whatnot. Squats. There were gonna be squats. So how's that ass? Can I bounce a quarter off it yet? I'll go to the bank and get quarters. Can practice. Man, boing, boing, boing.
You always know just how to brighten my day.
I will bring my quarters. That's fair. Although that reminds me of when I was in high school and we'd be doing science projects, and I swear to God that the guys were so immature, they would like try and pitch shit down our shirts. It's like, I didn't even have tits. I was like flat as a board when I was in high school. And they would still try and like get coins or bits of shit down there. And I'm like, why are you even trying? It's just annoying. But, you know, some boys gonna pull pigtails is what they do. All right, and we sneaks, then we sneaks, then we sneaks some more. Okay, Wynn, I'm glad that's not just me. That was memorable. Because I just remember being like, what are you trying to accomplish here? I wasn't wearing a super low-cut shirt, and I didn't have anything holding it open. So it was just like smashing my collarbone. popcorn in... No popcorn in the cleavage. Yeah, you get smelly. sneaks on out. Hey, look, we can rocket boost while we're sneaks on out. Because we go fast when we sneaks. Super sneaks, engage! I love this character so much. He sneaks, he dinks. Thank you, Wolfman. I will partake in one of my threat drops. Speaking of how I was going on about the amazing SWTOR streaming community, when I first started, I was having a lot of trouble with losing my voice, and Kitty Kisses recommended these Fisherman's Friend throat drops, and not gonna joke, bought a case. And then my mom was so sweet, she sent me chloroseptic throat spray. And now I start my days with tea and resting my voice. And now I don't have problems anymore. But it helps a lot when you guys remind me. Oh, Rob, you missed a lot of earlier then, man. We were having fun in some EC. Big bada boom. You swam most of your childhood. You were used to walking around in Speedos. Yep, everything out there in the budgie smuggler. That's what my old triathlon team called them, was budgie smugglers. They had matching ones. So I have these great pictures of the entire triathlon team and their red budgie smugglers. The two of us females got like the white sports bras and then the red budgie smuggler, because it fit like a bottom for us. It was hilarious. Let's just say, I knew every like line of all those guys. One of them even had a white triathlon suit. I don't know what was going through his brain when he purchased that, but man, he came out of the water and I was like, okay, that's everything. That's just a whole thing right there. Not a bad thing, but that's a whole thing. More sharing than I felt comfortable doing. Oh, an hour in. Let's see. I started at 6. Oh, a little bit before 6. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. We did Explosive Conflict, Eyeless, and TC were my story mode ops that I did today. We took the whole 2 hours, and that was fun. Should feel better now. Oh, I always feel better with you, Lana. You can make me feel better any day of the week. Or as Zio says, you're good, but I made you better. I love Zio. And sneaks on through. Day that ends in Y, so we're sneaks on through. Oh, but yeah, the guys in my story mode op today and I were having fun, because apparently one person or whatever in my guild complained about my making way too many sexual innuendos and whatnot, so I decided I can break my times in half. So I divided it into Tame Tuesdays and Thirsty Thursdays. So of course everyone was a little bitter, because of course Tuesday was Terror from Beyond, and you want to make it really easy to make all the sexual innuendos. I mean, it's Terror from Beyond. It's a fucking tentacle porn hentai with especially if you do it on vet mode, then you have to smash balls and don't stand in the spit. Ugh. You know, if you taunt it, it's gonna spit at you. All kinds of fun with that one. The first time I was learning tanking Dread Fortress, my leader was explaining like where I needed to stand on the last hands and fingers phase to direct the hands to smack the balls. And I was like, what? And then, of course, it was totally clear. Oh, stand at a 45 degree angle, and then the tentacle thing slaps the blue ball behind me. Tentacles, the way to end blue balls. You heard it here first.
Arkin locked down the whole network. He controls turbo lifts, blast doors, docking clamps, you name it. We need the main override station. It's on top of the control spar. I sent HK to clear a path.
Accommodation.
I have left you a trail of meat bags to follow, Master.
Well done, 50 HK. I love HK. All HK units are good HK units.
No more meat reinforcements. We'll get in, but someone has to hold this choke point.
That's my I'll choke you, Koth. To death.
It's up to you and Koth.
Crew.
Layer it up, Kogus.
They're buying us time. Let's use it well. If we don't free the gravestone, we're dead.
Not a thing I had to worry about with tennis. Tank top and short skirt. Good to go. Then, of course, I did fencing in college, and that's, like, the least attractive outfit ever, because thick white stuff that gets really sweaty. I mean, it looked kind of nice, but,
got you covered.
Not... Koth, I trust you about as far as I can kick you. Yeah, right, Rob? Yes. Because we are team, fuck Koth. Oh, got one. Koth, useless as a red anthill. Not even dangerous. Less useful. About as useful as a used dryer sheet. There we go. If you kick him in space, I imagine you can kick him. Yeah, right. Oh, no, I wouldn't waste the energy to kick him. Come on, just toss him in the airlock. And a walker.
Arkan brought all his toys.
Ooh, all his toys. Oh, different kind of toys. Damn. Not as fun.
Let's make this quick.
Koth, I couldn't expect you to last anyway. You don't strike me as a guy with stamina. Although that's the other thing, it breaks my heart knowing that Koth and Lana were actually an item. It is confirmed they were together while I was in Carbonite. Not okay. Lana's been desecrated. Lana made some bad decisions. So, woo, there we go. I can dismantle it. I was in the theater rehearsing musicals, so unless the girls were wearing dance clothes, we all make mistakes, even Lana. No. Lana girl, best girl. I mean, she doesn't fully betray you, but I don't know, sleeping with Koth, that's pretty nasty. That's pretty nasty. That's just like bad life choices. I know, well, Mavit was in Carbonite, so. Right, Rob? It's bad, but Mina got the screenshots to prove it. It happened. Lana, you deserve better. You deserve a guy who can actually fly a ship without crashing it.
Emperor Valkorion talks to you, right? Do you have any advice?
He's giving me the silent treatment.
He's probably got a lot on your mind. The Emperor is a great man.
No, he's not.
Arkan. It's him.
If you knew what I'd do about him, you'd run. The man killed billions.
Billions with a B. It's a lot of dead planets. Gah!
Reminder,
yeah, and Hitler was good to parts of Germany, too, you fuckity fuck. Extra fuckity fuck, Koth. Hey, don't diss Renfairs, by the way. Oh, I see what you did there, Zwav. That shouldn't have taken me that long. is that the way to make a woman make bad decisions? Or does it require a Renfair and a hot tub? Flying a ship without crashing it definitely counts Koth out. Exactly, right? My expectations aren't high. I hate this asymmetrical ship. It's upsetting to me. It just doesn't make sense. Must have other wing. Two wings. One on each side. Even the Lambda shuttles are at least symmetrical.
The main override control station's just ahead. Whatever happens, I want you to know.
Oh, so Axios, I actually got so annoyed with Quinn bitching to Koth to Moxzilla about not wanting to go down on Hoth that I stripped him of his shirt and kept him in just his shorts, his shoes, and his blaster. All he had was pants, shoes, and blasters while we did the entirety of Hoth. That is reserved for Malavi Quinn. I actually did that though.
Follow me.
It was amazing.
I'll get you through this alive.
You stole my battle cry. Let's find that droid.
Okay. Can we sneaks? I bet we can sneaks. Hello! Just passing through. No one here but us chickens. Oh, and by chickens I mean Koth. I'm an awesome, you know, Sith warrior. Or, well, assassin. It's a tank. Okay, gotta kill Delothrea. Interesting name. Hey, Pops! Good to see you, man. Chickens? What chickens? Oh, Koth. Fucking Koth, man. It's okay. I have HK. HK's got my back.
Oh good! There's more!
You're useless to me, Koth. Die in a fire. All he does is bitch. Woo! Good job, HK. Fuck you, Koth.
There's a whole battalion of Sakul Knights headed your way.
There, see? That's a properly shaped ship. Plan. You would almost say it's ship shape.
But not. Whatever it takes, get the gravestone flying.
Have a meaningful death. Because fuck you, Koth.
Frontal assault will only get you killed. At least make them chase you somewhere first.
Nice idea, but I've never been much of a sprinter.
Right? Thank you, thank you. I'll be here all night. Well, at least a little longer.
We'll get this done. You
do the same. Koth's military training was unorthodox, to say the least. Those knights don't know how to defend against him and HK.
Yeah, I'm giving HK the credit, not Koth. Duh. Obviously Koth is the doer there. Or HK. Jesus Christ. In HK we trust. Aw, thanks for the cheers. If you manage to push Koth off a cliff, that'll be a Koth drop. Drop it like it's Koth. let's see, can we sneaks? Yes, we can. Can we sneaks it? Yes, we can. And have a nice little nap. I love this character so much. We sneaks, we push, we slam, we tank. Aww, we love the gonks. Gonks are so cute. Everyone likes a gonk droid. Night is a cool. No, I swear, I heard a chicken distinct. Bark, 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 bark. Cough, 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 cough. My, what a big deck you have. It'd be a shame if someone, you know, stabbed a lightsaber into each a console.
Expecting at least a token guard.
Oh, Lana, I'll give you more than a token guard. It's quiet. Too quiet. Right, basket. I'd be like over at that far console tucked up there, and I just have my little space heater right next to me. That's all. That's actually what I did. So when my ex-husband and I moved to Utah for a year and a half, our rental house was like way too big. It was ridiculous because rent there is, you can get a lot of house for no money. So instead of heating the whole house when it was cold as fuck, I would just have my tiny space heater up in my office next to me. Like, that one room would be 68 degrees and everything else would be, like, low 40s. My husband would get home from work and be like, what the fuck? Like, I'm not paying to heat three floors of 4,000 square feet of house when it's just me. That said, Basket, you have to remember it's a spaceship, so we're assuming heat is the thing we're making a lot of, so that would be easy to dissipate. It's keeping things cool that's difficult with electronics. Logic check! Vidya, welcome! Hope you're having a lovely evening. My name's Moxie. I frequently teach story mode operations, and then sometimes I dick around on fun characters like this. Earlier this evening, I taught story mode EC, Eyeless, and TC, and tomorrow night at 5 p.m. Pacific, I have no idea what I'll be teaching. I'm covering for someone else, and he hasn't made up his mind yet.
No one is invincible.
And then Saturday is going to be fun. I'm going to be taking alongside Marcus for his 1 year streamiversary for some story modes with him. And just generally babbling and having fun with him. Hey, glad to hear you're good. All right, let's kill Arkan again, because it's what we do. Day that ends in Y must end him. Although I did marry him on one of my, well, not marry, but got in a relationship with. And force choke! And throw a sticky grenade. And run away. Pathetic. I'm not pathetic, you are. More like Arcant. Basket, dude. You are always so on point. I love it. Fire! Boom. Trip. Kick. Crunch, smash.
Now you will die.
No, I don't think I will, for I am Darth Mavit, and I'm kind of sexy. So. good times. I love this storyline, though.
To the void with you.
Ooh, a void. Oh, well, okay, if you're trying to get rid of your father, stop attacking me. We can talk about this. Trust me, Valkorion, not here all the time. Woo!
Master!
No, not my HK! HK. Welcome, the Mappers. Hope you're having a lovely evening.
I can't wait to meet.
Good to have all you new folks with us. Happy Earth Day indeed. Hell yeah. I took a trash bag and gloves out when I walked my dog this morning and picked up cigarette butts and other little bits of trash. That's my annual Earth Day tradition. I should do it more often than just Earth Day. Much appreciated. Good to have you always. I'm so glad Kokus introduced us.
You can't tempt me. When Arkan's done, you'll...
Aw, yay gardening. I wish I had a garden. I have an arrow garden. So my like little electric hydroponic thing, I have basil and currently parsley. And I loves it. I use all the basil, and I just like raped my poor parsley yesterday for this amazing recipe. Oh my god, with these mushrooms and just hummus. It was decadent. I was very, very proud of how it came out. I love to cook. Nice, nice. Well, I mean, I have a 900 square foot apartment, so there's only so much I can do. And I'm 5 floors up. But yeah, that hydroponic, my mom got it for me when, at like near the beginning of COVID, when I was like, okay, you know what? I'm like upping my cooking game. I've always been a really good cook, but like I took it up like 18,000 notches this year. It's been so cool. Yes, I love the thing. I've switched out different herbs over the last year, but like the dill was fantastic. I just don't use it enough. hey, pups, be nice. Oh, excuse me, pause. I need a last kiss with Lana.
I think this might be the right time and place.
Stop talking.
Swoon. I love you, Lana.
Free. Get back or get left.
Tora. You're such a fucking cockblock. Burn in hell, bitch. Burn in hell. Oh, that was fantastic. Everything I dreamt it could be and more. Well, since my beloved friend and moderator Mina like kind of claimed Tori or Theron Sean as her love interest, and we got having way too much fun in our fanfics having our characters overlap, and we were like, well, that just can't work, we can't both have Theron. So I decided to be like, you know what, I'm gonna jump off the creative ledge here, and I created Darth Mobbit. His first name is Darian, and he's amazing, and I love him mostly because I created him. So, you know, that makes life really good, and this is why I'll never get married again. Unless I can create him. How far will AI go in the next few years? Lanabot. Hands down the best male voice for playable. Absolutely, Rob. His voice is just seduction incarnate. Except for when my other moderator, Astrocella Kevin, gets on here and chats with us, then everyone decides to go swoon for Kevin's voice. He does have a very, very sexy voice. It's, it's muchly. Speak of the devil and he shall appear. I mean... Kevin, I jumped into mods. If you want to join us and put in your 2 cents and grace the people. Oh, pups, it's Gonzo meets Elmo, put on meth, and holding a butter knife when the cops try to talk him down. It's a great visual.
Don't want to hurt you.
That was amazing,
I
pups.
I liked you better when you were dead.
She never was dead, Valen, you fuckwit. Oh, beautiful eyes, Senya. That was a really cool close-up of her eyes. She had really neat eyes. Hey, Rob, you know, whatever does it for you, man. Again, we make very clear we are a no judgment zone. Yeah, pups. she wasn't going to kill her. Kevin has graced us with his presence.
I've got like 5 minutes to fall asleep.
Well, you use them wisely, right? Thank you for keeping me alive during explosive conflict earlier.
Oh, you're welcome.
Was it fun getting to learn the heal mechanic there?
It was more than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, that fight is tricky even on story mode if you don't know the bits and pieces.
Yeah, and having done it only on my Sentinel the first time, it's really brainless. Like, jump right in, jump to ads.
You put your right foot in, you put your right foot out, you put your right foot in, and you smash the tank about. Uh-huh. I mean, yes. That fight on story mode, totally different. Yes.
The spike swap, I didn't like the spike swap.
Yep. And there's spikes, and people weren't paying attention to the timers on their own. They were relying way too much on me to tell them. I need to break them of that.
What do you want me to say? The mellifluous guppy ran to the caribou? Know what that what does it for you?
Pups, what the fuck, man? XO, I love tanking and healing. Tanking and DPS. I do not heal. Under no circumstances. I've tried. It ended poorly for everyone. I like tanking because it's easier to lead operations. But DPS, a little less stress. Stand and pew pew. But yeah, Kevin is an amazing healer. I just need to drag him into more of my events. Again, people with lives and fucker's got a girlfriend. Ugh. Can't make everything revolve around me. David Letterman had a top 10 list once of things that sound cool when said by James Earl Jones, and a couple of those words were in that list. Interesting.
Nice. I should find that for one of our next Friday.
Like, that needs to happen. Things that sound sexy when Kevin says them. Here, have a dictionary. Let me just buy you an Encyclopedia Britannica, yeah? You can just.
You guys have me read something out of one of my books at some point.
Oh God, yes. Right, that was when Mina had that game about like grab your closest book and switch to page 206, and that first line is your sex life. And mine was like an arid desert.
Barren?
It's like, oh yeah, it was a barren desert. And I'm like, too true. Too true.
A little on the nose.
It was a little rough. Kind of like when the eight ball picks on Zwoff. Like, every single time, it's, aren't you a little short for Stormtrooper? Every fucking time. I don't know
what Zwoff did to the magic eight ball. But it was awful.
I swear to God, that thing is random. I did not program any more logic into it than giving it that list and making it random. Night, Awen. Have a good one. Thanks for joining us. Is Zwoff being good? Take a shot. Zwoff is never being good. We know this about Zwoff.
Yeah, he's actually being suspiciously quiet.
Yeah, that's worrisome. Have Kevin.
I can't sing. That's my fatal flaw. Unexpected setback. Has Zwoff ever been good? No.
See, Dave Ball knows. Dave Ball knows. I'm going. Which song? The The really pretty one that the one hobbit sings?
Or like the drinking song.
Or the drinking song on the table, because that one's fun.
Your body went through quite an ordeal.
But I couldn't sing either.
Never met anybody who took a lightsaber to the gut and lived to tell.
The magic eight ball knows.
Not without special help.
If Valkorion is healing you, it's for his own purposes.
Magic eight ball knows all.
While I was
out.
The gravestone is still, all knows all.
But I lost some crew back on Asylum. Senya hadn't saved
its
day,
answers are
worse.
Meaningful. It Len gives us purpose and life and direction.
It's kind of embarrassing. I still don't trust Senya.
I didn't think it would be that powerful.
She was there when it mattered.
Oh, the misty man.
We did suffer another loss.
Will Moxie marry Theron or no?
Present when HK.
That's no moon. Yes. See? Ah, April knows all. Neither.
He fought to defend me.
Exactly. It's a trap. Both. Neither. Never.
It was always destined to be.
I don't marry traitors.
I will deactivate you.
I won't marry again. Period.
This all started when Heskel summoned you.
Dead. What about Theron?
He's the one.
Nope.
Mina's not here, so we can call Theron a traitor.
Yeah, Theron, you know, kind of threw me out of a train.
Tried to blow up that train.
With me and Lana Girl, Best Girl. So
I know.
He wasn't even just going for me. He was hurting my beloved Lana, too. So, no. Just, you know what? No.
You're about to become the leader of an alliance dedicated to bringing down the Eternal Throne once and for all.
Uh-oh.
Everyone's waiting on a planet called the Desert.
Wait, I don't want to be in charge.
You should say hello.
Wait! I don't want to be in charge!
Here we go again.
Pups. You know, I do have alternate outfits for him, but... this one brings me pleasure. Why would you deny me pleasure?
Yeah, this will help.
Do you want to deny me pleasure? Don't you think I'm deserving of some joy in this world? Does Mavic in a shirt rely on your companions?
That's a no.
That's a no.
Okay, formal effects is good. That's very funny.
That's insanely, amazingly awesome. Oh. Do you have your formal pecs? Yes, I keep them in the closet with my formal buttocks.
I have to protect myself. We'll be safe.
Are we sure it's wise to be Scorpio
and control the bridge? Are those his black tie pecs.
So, why this?
Hey, Solomon, good to have you with us. I am yet again being teased mercilessly about the outfit in which my beloved Sith assassin, Darth Mavit, is currently clothed.
Me on this path to begin with. Led me to forge a certain
No, Zwaf, we've established he's a really bad dancer, remember? Mina gave me the waltz, and he does a really, like, awkward box step.
Really is terrible.
It's horrid. It's a bad box step, and like I'm a decent enough dancer to know that.
The Swatari still likes the No Bones dance.
Oh yeah, No Bones is like woo.
That was real goofy.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Hey pups, he has pants. He has pants. No, Solomon, I actually cannot. Because I am in Knights of the Fallen Empire, I can't switch my companions. But you can Google those very easily. May the Google Foo be strong with you.
This is your new alliance.
But, I am not in charge.
It's not my alliance. We're all in this together.
Lana in charge.
May well be, but they
all
need someone to rally
together.
Someone to motivate them.
Get myself from flushing Senya out of the airlock at least 5 times because of you.
Certain way. Yes.
show them what
back in the airlock, Koth. Back in the airlock. With you, not Senya. We like Senya. Do I know slave outfit? Of course. I'm actually, you know, pretty expert at Star Wars things. It is known, Khaleesi. Shit, wrong fandom. Live long and prosper. Shit, wrong fandom. May the force be with you. Or, as our beloved Lana Girl Best Girl says, may the force be ever in your service. No, may the force ever serve you?
I think it's may the force ever serve you.
Yeah. He'd give an inspiring speech.
I'd like everyone's attention. The galaxy as we knew it is gone. The institutions we know have fallen. But we can't let that be a source of...
I'll fall on my back for you. I mean, what? I'm trying here. I'm trying.
We have an opportunity to build something together. An alliance each of us can be vested in.
Yes, pups.
We don't all share the same ideologies, but every one of you is...
No, you share my ideology. Come on. Weird what goes, Wuv? Okay. Ah, my own little planet. Look at that swing. Koth must be driving. Yeah. Right? Don't let that man near the load lifters. Like, together, no.
Or we fail alone. Let's not fail.
Let's not fail. A wild Theron appeared. Looking a little worse for the wear. Ooh, sexy music.
I got you done with the...
Why am I getting sexy music? Down boy. We're friends. I made it very clear I'm with Lana. Mobbit Street.
It's great.
Not too late for Theron.
Good.
Not in... No. Sure, based on what Lana... We did not flirt with Theron.
What you're going through.
There was never any flirting with Theron. I don't know why we got the sexy saxophone music there. It's very Kenny G, right?
A long 5 years. Feels like everything's changed.
Oh, baby. Your jacket didn't.
Why don't you get me up to speed?
I will. But before we dig into the big stuff, I've got something for you.
You found my people.
No luck so far, but...
Pops, you're amazing. Theron looks like he went to get a piercing at Radio Shack.
Yikes. Alright, I need to call it a night.
Have a most lovely evening, Kevin. Thanks for jumping in for a bit and coming along for story mode ops earlier. That was a blast.
No worries. That's fine.
See
good
you
night, good night,
on
everyone.
Sunday.
It's time for that official stuff. I'll be inside.
Ooh, official stuff. Good night, Deep Voice Bar Raiser. I know, Kevin sets the bar pretty high. Sexy voice and a good friend. And just generally pleasant person. We need more of those in this world. All right, but he is right about many, many things. Most of all, that it is late. And now, ooh, here I am with Lana Girl Best Girl. So I think I'm going to leave Mavit and Lana to make some future plans of their own for the evening and sign off here. Let's see, is anyone else streaming right now? It's a quiet night with the Spotor community. Thank you all so much for joining. I look forward to seeing you. I will be on tomorrow at around 4:45 Pacific to kick off my story mode ops group that I'll be teaching with my guild. So I really look forward to seeing you all there. Thanks again for all the fun, the new followers. So glad to have you all with us. Always those subs make my heart sing. And you know, everything we can do to build the SWTOR community. You guys rock my socks, like, wow. So without further ado, have a most wonderful night, and Moxie out.